on the Badger Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the Wisconsin football dream season, presented by American Family Insurance.
35-30, there he goes, to the 20, to the 10, to the 5, touchdown, Wisconsin, 51 yards.
Also brought to you by your Wisconsin and UP Ford dealers, inviting you to visit your local Ford store or buyfordnow.com. UW Health Sports Medicine, treating the Badgers, treating you. Visit uwsportsmedicine.org. Dairyland Seed, proud partner of Wisconsin football and Wisconsin farmers. And by American Family Insurance, insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Here's the voice of the Badgers, Matt LePay.
Welcome to the American Family Insurance pregame show, as today we take a look back to November 2014, a Badger Classic as Wisconsin takes on the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Two teams that have some explosive weapons on the offensive side of the ball, and the Badgers looking to get it cranked up as they hit the stretch drive of the regular season. Let's take a look at the starting lineups presented by U.S. Bank. U.S. Bank, a proud sponsor of the Wisconsin Badgers. We take a look at the Nebraska Cornhuskers on offense. Some explosive weapons led by quarterback Tommy Armstrong. And a good running back duel today. Nebraska brings Amir Abdullah to the table. And some very good wide receivers led by Kenny Bell. For the Badgers on offense, we talked about the running back duel. They have Abdullah. The Badgers have Melvin Gordon. And helping pave the way is fullback Derek Watt. And a terrific offensive line anchored by Robbie Havenstein. Of course, Joel Stavi is your quarterback. Moving to the Huskers on defense, we'll keep an eye on defensive end Randy Gregory as well as safety Nate Geary. For the Badgers on defense, Joe Schobert, the outstanding outside linebacker, helping lead the way along with his fellow outside backer Vince Beagle. Let's check out today's NFL spotlight as we look at a former Badger who has gone on to make a name for himself in the NFL. Yeah, I would say Joe Schobert is making a name for himself in the NFL. Fourth round pick by the Cleveland Browns back in 2016. Has a Pro Bowl appearance on his resume. Finished his first year with the Jacksonville Jaguars this past season. His first 5 years in the league. He's played in 77 games, has 11 sacks and 9 interceptions. We'll continue to get you ready for that 2014 game between the Badgers and Nebraska as our American Family pregame show continues. This is the Wisconsin football dream season on Learfield IMG College.
Buying your first home is the start of realizing bigger dreams with your family. That's why it's important to protect everything you love with American Family Insurance. Wait, what's that?
It's their dream car.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. It's actually my dream car. And my little dream tire swing with some dream trees. There'd be a nice dream garden right here, too.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance.
Insure carefully, dream fearlessly.
Rocket drive block? Rush a soul crush? Jam a grand slam? Drunk? Drunk? That'd be insane! Roll in that? Roll in this? Roll together? Drunk?
That would be super insane.
Hey, all you ladies.
And guys.
Drive sober on the road.
No matter how many wheels you roll.
Preparation. It's the key to success on game day. And like your favorite Badgers on the field, you need to be ready right from the opening kickoff. Cenex has your pregame routine covered. We've got your salty snacks, your sweet treats, ice-cold beverages to wash them down, and fresh tanks of propane to fire up the grill. Fuel your fandom at your local Cenex station. Badger Pride, powered locally.
We continue with the American Family Insurance pregame show as we turn back the clock to November of 2014 as the Wisconsin Badgers take on the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Let's check out the home field advantage for today's game, presented by Carrier. Going into this season, the Badgers had two regular season trophy games. Well, in 2014, a third regular season trophy game was born. The first time the Freedom Trophy was at stake. Since the Freedom Trophy's debut in 2014, you'll be interested to know the Badgers are 6-0 against Nebraska. Badger fans, give your home field an advantage with energy-efficient home heating and cooling systems by Carrier. Find your local Carrier expert at www.carrier.com/residential today. Now let's take a quick look at the field and weather conditions presented by Dairyland Sea. 26 degrees, pretty good November weather really for kickoff. A light wind out of the west at 5 miles per hour. You'll remember as the game went on, we had some snow, which gave us a classic scene for a classic game. Badgers and the Nebraska Cornhuskers, November of 2014 at Camp Randall Stadium. Stay with us. The opening kick presented by Odyssey Greek Yogurt is just moments away. Kick off your day with thick, creamy, and all-natural Greek yogurt with real flavorful fruit. Odyssey Greek Yogurt. This is the Wisconsin football dream season from Learfield IMG College.
My favorite breakfast is Odyssey Yogurt. I asked Mommy where it comes from, and she took me to a dairy farm to learn all about milk and, most importantly, cows. Wisconsin cows are definitely the happiest, which means they make the tastiest yogurt. My favorite is blueberry. What's your flavor? Support your local farmers. EIEI Odyssey.
They better get season tickets right now, because before long, they probably won't be able to.
Doubles into the end zone! Wisconsin wins the Rose Bowl!
Big Ten champion!
Ron Dayne down the left sideline!
And there it is!
You do not want him in your secondary.
Back-to-back Rose Bowl champions!
Matt Shaver to Lee Evans. Ball is loose. Badgers have it.
And this game is underway with a bang. And the Wisconsin Badgers are Big Ten champions.
I want you high.
Caught by Duckwood. The Wisconsin Badgers are headed to Pasadena.
Touch the flame where the sheets have no name.
The Wisconsin Badgers have won their fifth consecutive bowl game.
On the Badger Sports Network from Learfield IMG College, this is the Wisconsin football dream season presented by American Family Insurance.
Here comes Melvin to the 25, to the 20, Gordon 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Wisconsin! Record-breaking run, Melvin Gordon, 4-0-8.
Also brought to you by Odyssey Greek Yogurt, made in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Johnsonville, a family-owned Wisconsin-based company and a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics, served with pride since 1945. Alliant Energy, powering beyond. And by U.S. Bank, helping individuals and businesses work toward their financial goals. Equal housing lender, member FDIC. It's game time. Here's Matt LePay and Mike Lucas.
Kicking off for Nebraska's Mauro Bondi, who had been hurt. He will handle the kickoff duties for the Huskers. Kenzel Doe, Corey Clement deep for the Badgers. They'll receive, go right to left, south to north, first quarter. And the kick is in the air, and Kenzel Doe will wait for it, a yard deep, right side coming out, 5 to the 10, 15, 20. And Kenzel Doe is slam to the turf, shy of the 25-yard line. Jonathan Rose down there in kick coverage for the Huskers. Badgers start at their 24, and we are underway, and let's send it down to the sideline. Patrick Herb standing by.
Matt, you gave the early conditions report. They're calling the official temperature at kickoff 26 degrees, which is historical. It's the coldest game in Camp Randall since 1964, almost to the day 50 years ago when Wisconsin beat Minnesota 14-7 and it was 11 degrees out. So it could be worse, but it's the coldest in 50 years. Insert your joke about Mike Lucas now.
Please, do.
Put it right on a tee.
Saw that game.
First and 10 for the Badgers from their own 24-yard line. Kenzel Dell wide right, motions to the left. Joel Stabby, the quarterback. Hand off Melvin Gordon, trying the left side. And Randy Gregory closed the door immediately. Down goes Melvin for a loss of 1 to the 23 of Wisconsin, second and 11.
Now, Joel Stabby does have some history with Nebraska. His second career start, first Big Ten start, came at Lincoln in 2012. He threw for 214 yards, had a real strong first half to lead the Badgers. Second half wasn't so hot.
And we're seeing the tag team quarterback rotation as Tanner McAvoy is in now on second and 11 for the Badgers from their own 23-yard line. Four receivers, two either side. McAvoy in the shotgun, and now Kenzel Doe slot right, motions to the backfield, and here's the give to Kenzel, running left, 25-yard line, and the ball popped loose, and Nebraska trying to pounce, and they will. Zaire Anderson, outside linebacker, covers it up for the Huskers inside the 30-yard line in Wisconsin territory.
And the hit was applied by 90, Greg McMullen, the defensive end, who jarred the ball loose from Doe as the made contact with the turf.
Both of these teams go into the game with minus numbers in turnover margin, but that ball clearly came out, and Anderson recovers, and the first big opportunity of the day belongs to the Cornhuskers. First and 10, Nebraska at the Wisconsin 29-yard line. Huskers go north to south, left to right first quarter. Come out with four receivers. Pistol formation, Amir Abdullah behind the quarterback, Tommy Armstrong. Here's the snap, handoff, Abdullah running left, slips a tackle, spin move, 25, down to the 21-yard line. And with a brace on the left knee, Abdullah looking strong in his first run of the day, a gain of 8 yards.
That should have been a 3-yard loss, but Vince Beagle couldn't pull him down from the backside.
Derek Landish on the stop, second and two Huskers at the Wisconsin 21-yard line. Two receivers right, one on the left. Abdullah will shift to the left of Armstrong. Bell in motion left to right, and Armstrong fakes the handoff, keeps it off the left edge inside the 20-yard line. Sojourn Shelton will take him out of bounds. Armstrong to the 17 of Wisconsin. First down for the Huskers, now into the red zone.
That was an instance there. Beagle had to hold contain. He got sucked down by the fake to Abdullah and allowing Armstrong to get the edge and pick up the first down.
Terrell Newby now in it. Running back, we call it the eye back here for Nebraska. He lines up behind Armstrong in the pistol, and now Newby will shift to the left of the QB. Abdullah, one of the three receivers right, motions left. Armstrong faced the handoff to him, throws over the middle, in zone, incomplete. Intended for Kenny Bell over the middle, about 5 yards deep into the end zone. They cannot connect. It'll be second and 10 for the Huskers at the Wisconsin 17-yard line.
That's a tough formation to defend, where they put Abdullah in the slot, bring him in motion. So now you have the equivalent of two tailbacks. Abdullah also a pretty good pass receiver.
Yes, 13 catches on the year does Amir Abdullah, who now lines up behind Armstrong. Three receivers right, one on the left. Abdullah will shift to the left of Armstrong. Second and 10 Huskers at the Wisconsin 17-yard line. Snap to Armstrong, and he'll hand off to Abdullah running right. Landish slows him down and then gets some help. Abdullah to the 15, maybe a shade inside of it. Third down coming up for Nebraska. We're 2 minutes in, no score. Ball resting just inside the 15 of Wisconsin. Third and 8 for the Huskers.
It's a nice job there by Landis. He had to read that out, was able to kind of flow back across the formation to get him down on the ground to set up this third down.
Three receivers right, one on the left. Abdullah to the left of the quarterback. At the Badgers 15-yard line, third and 8 for Nebraska. Only one defensive lineman with a hand on the ground. Play clock at 3, at 2. Armstrong calls for the ball, takes the snap. Quick shot over the middle, and it's broken up at the 5-yard line. Good work by Derek Tindall, breaking up the pass intended for Brandon Riley. And Nebraska with a golden opportunity to get into the end zone, will not get there as on comes the field goal team. Drew Brown, a freshman, will try a 32-yarder. He has missed three of his last four attempts. This will be a 32-yard poke just a little bit left of center. Nebraska trying to capitalize on the Wisconsin turnover. Here's the snap, kick is in the air, and Nebraska is first on the board. So the Huskers get three off the Kenzel Doe fumble.
U.S. Bank is a proud sponsor of Wisconsin Athletics. If you have a smartphone or tablet, you can have your bank with you wherever you go. With U.S. Bank Mobile, you'll spend less time managing your money and more time doing the things you love. Sign up today at usbank.com or your app store. Restrictions and fees may apply. U.S. Bank National Association, member FDIC.
On this game day, Good Foods Guacamole would like to salute all you players, no matter what you seem to be playing. You, sir, are a winner. You, ma'am, triumphant, and thumbs up to whatever it is you're doing. So let's hoist a guac-laden chip to all you players out there. Good Foods Guac, made from the freshest avocado and the cleanest ingredients. So here's to all the players and whatever game it is they're trying to play. Game day is guac day. Good Foods Guac.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet on the sunny side of the street.
If we build this, all the legendary players will magically appear and we'll have sports again. I call it the Field of Fame. Of course, I'll have to tear down the garage, fill in the pool, and lose the trees. So can I get a loan?
So as your friend, I love it, but
as your banker, not so much.
Let me talk to the friend.
You could always invest in a college fund.
No, my kids aren't going to college. They're going to work at the stadium.
Our kids are going to college.
Sports are back.
My wife wants to build a college.
And not a moment too soon.
Kenzel Doe and Corey Clement deep for the Badgers. Riley did block a punt last week. Nebraska blocked two punts early in that, or 2 weeks ago in their last game against Purdue, a game where the Huskers just had crazy good field position for much of that game against the Boilermakers. Bondi with the kick in the air. Kenzel Doe, another opportunity at the one. Right side five to the 10. 15 across the 20, gets labeled, and down he goes at about the 23-yard line. Took a good shot from Josh Banderas, linebacker working on kick coverage for the Huskers, and Wisconsin will begin actually at its own 22-yard line, first and 10.
Matt, it's encouraging, it's encouraging to see 34 back in service for Wisconsin. That's Derek Watt. He's had a frustrating season with injuries, to say the least.
Yeah, had to miss last week's game. Watt issue kept him out in the game against the Boilermakers. Watt is the fullback. Gordon is the tailback. Joel Stabby, the quarterback. Under his center, Dan Volt. Straight eye formation. Receivers either side. Here's the handoff to Gordon off the right side across the 25-yard line. Gain of about three plus change. Second down and seven coming up for Wisconsin at the Badgers' 25-yard line.
Just a simple lead play off the right side. A nice job by Havenstein of getting the defensive end off the line of scrimmage, allowing for a little bit of room. It's going to be tough sledding here today. Gordon's going to have to pick up some tough yards inside.
Double wide to the left. Erickson is wide. Dole in the slot. Single back offense. Melvin Gordon behind Joel Stavi from the Badger 25-yard line. Take the quick toss. Now Stavi fakes the handoff. Back to throw. Fires it over the middle. High pass incomplete. One at Erickson. At the 40-yard line, Corey Cooper, one of the safeties, back there on coverage for the Huskers. And the Badgers looking at a third and eight from their own 25-yard line. We're about 3.5 minutes in, 3-0 Nebraska.
It's not an exaggeration. He threw into triple coverage. There were three defenders around Erickson.
With Cooper the closest to the three.
This is the scenario Wisconsin is trying to avoid, third and seven. For the trying to pick up a first down.
Randy Gregory, defensive end, put a pretty good thumping on Stavi That last play, Joel back to throw. Pockets tight, gets away from Gregory to stop. He throws left side. That buzzes over the head of Jordan Frederick. Incomplete coverage from Josh Mitchell at the 28 of the near side in Badger territory, and Wisconsin is forced to punt from its own 25.
Tosh, you can see the quick get off, the quickness overall of Randy Gregory already causing some problems for Tyler Merritt.
One of the issues, besides not being a great passing team, pass protection, these guys off the edge are very good players and are going to give the tackles all kinds of trouble. That's another reason you need to stay normal down at distance.
Bart Houston, punt formation, line of scrimmage, the Badger 25. Pearson held deep near the 50. A little rugby roll to the right, and it's a hard ground ball up the middle across midfield. It goes off a Husker, and the Badgers recover just on the Nebraska side of the 50. That was a hard ground ball from Bart Houston. One of the Cornhuskers tried to scoop it up, and not very wisely so. Well, the officials are still having a conference about it. The Badgers convinced they have it, but we have not seen the official word, the official signal from the crew.
It was Joe Schobert, wasn't it? Who was down there?
The field was the ball was first touched by a kicking team member. As a result, the receiving team takes possession of the ball at the spot of the first touch.
That was referee John O'Neill, the voice you're hearing, and they're saying that it went off a Badger first. That was a hook, and that was a very, very good call by this crew. That went off of James McGuire, the long snapper, and that was not McGuire's fault. He's just running down the field, and Bart Houston ended up kicking a curveball that went right. It got McGuire in the back or in the shoulder, and Nebraska catches a break and again has great field position at the Wisconsin 43, first and 10. Abdullah, the running back, to the right of Armstrong. Four receivers, two either way. Movement up front, left side of the Nebraska offensive line, and a false start is called. That was the left tackle, Alex Lewis, coming up a little quick.
It's the Colorado transfer. They've had to retool their entire offensive line. That's why they've used a rotation up front. They took some serious graduation hits.
It'll be first and 15 for the Huskers now at the Badger 48-yard line. 11:20 left in the first quarter. It's 3-0 Nebraska. It's just an 18-yard punt there from Bart Houston. Here's the fake handoff. Armstrong keeping it over the right side. Gets inside the 40-yard line of Wisconsin. And they will mark at the 39-yard line in Badger territory. Tommy Armstrong brought down on the play by Darius Hillary. And the Huskers get right back on the ball. Second down and 6 from the Badger 39-yard line. Armstrong takes the snap. He'll give it to Abdullah off the right side. Breaks a tackle, 35. Abdullah the 30 and down to the 25-yard line of Wisconsin. Near Abdullah looking strong in the early moments of this game. First down for the Huskers as they are back on the move. Joe Schobert on the stop for Wisconsin.
It's a type of running back that's not going to come down with an arm tackle. We've seen that already.
10:45 left first quarter. 3-0 the Huskers, and they're threatening. Andy Janovich, fullback in the game, to the right of Armstrong. Abdullah behind the quarterback. And penalty marker, illegal substitution, I believe.
12 players in formation. 5-yard penalty. First down.
It was against Wisconsin. Let's quickly check in with Patrick Herb.
Well, we've had two pre-snap penalties already on this drive. That's significant because Nebraska is a look-over offense. The first one Wisconsin has played this year, meaning they get to the line of scrimmage, then look over to the bench for the play call, then go back. Wisconsin is trying to do a look-over also, saying if Nebraska changes, we're going to change too. A little chess match before the snap on each play.
They place it at the 20 of Wisconsin, so it's second down at 5. Here's a handoff to Abdullah off the right side, and he'll crash his way close to the stick. He needs a 15 to stop just shy of it. Marcus Trotter among those in on the play defensively for Wisconsin. Chikwe Obashi first on the scene. Third down and less than a yard. We'll call it the 16 of Wisconsin. Nebraska threatening again, leading 3-0. We are 5 minutes into the game. Four receivers, two on the right, two on the left. Armstrong in the gun, Abdullah to his left. Armstrong takes the snap. He'll hand to Abdullah. Gets the first down, running behind the right side of the line, down to about the 12-yard line. Vince Beagle on the tackle.
It's zone read really puts a lot of pressure on a defense. Find the ball, because so far Armstrong's done a pretty good job being very deceptive on whether he's going to hand it off or keep it himself.
It's a really nice combination block by their center, Mark Pelini, and their right guard, Mike Moody, to allow Abdullah to pick up that first down.
Mark Pelini, the nephew of head coach Bo Pelini, trips to the left. Abdullah, the running back, to the left of Tommy Armstrong for the Badgers 12-yard line. First and 10, Nebraska. Now Abdullah to the right of Armstrong, who is back to throw, looking, pop fly, left side, end zone, Kenny Bell, and he makes the catch, touchdown Nebraska. And Kenny Bell, right in front of the Nebraska rooting section, takes a bow. His team now leads 9-0.
And that was not contested by Michael Caputo. He had about 2 yards separation. Nice, easy throw for Armstrong.
Puts a lot of pressure on Caputo and some of these safeties that when you have that read option, all that ball, all the ball faking, you're blitzing people, you're leaving these guys out on an island, and that time Nebraska won the battle.
And Abdullah doing some nice work picking up that pressure in the backfield, giving his quarterback time as Kenny Bell, the all-time leader, not just in receptions, but receiving yards with that touchdown catch. And the extra point is in the air, and it is good. So the Huskers have had great field position, and they are taking advantage of it.
Badger fans, American Family Insurance wants you to win 2021 Badger football season tickets. Enter now at amfam.com/badgers.
Rocket drive block? Rush a soul crush? Jam a grand slam? Drunk? Drunk? That'd be insane! Roll in that? Roll in this? Roll together? Drunk?
That would be super insane!
Hey, all you ladies and guys. Drive sober on the road.
No matter how many wheels you roll.
Cancer is often detected too late. At Exact Sciences, we're working to change lives by helping to detect cancer earlier. Headquartered in Madison, Exact Sciences is growing and needs dedicated, energetic individuals to join our team. You don't have to be a scientist to work at Exact Sciences. We're hiring for our laboratory and customer care teams and have hundreds of job openings for people of all backgrounds and experience levels. Visit exactsciences.com to learn more and join the fight against cancer. Change careers, change lives. Exact Sciences.
As we prepare to move forward, stay healthy. Appreciate life. Be safe. Treasure moments. Plan well.
Record-setting catch that was. As Mike just mentioned, Mario Bondi with the kick in the air, and waiting for it is Kenzel Bell. He'll backpedal 5 yards deep, take the touchback. Wisconsin will begin at its 25-yard line. 9:21 left in this first quarter. 10-0 Nebraska.
See how much poise the offense has in handling the early adversity, sporting adversity that they faced in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is a case where you have to stick to what you're doing. This is where you need to lean on what you're good at. And what Wisconsin is good at is running the football and play action pass. So that's what you need. You need to get some first downs here, keep the defense off the field, and get a little bit of a rhythm started offensively.
Tanner McAvoy in at quarterback again for Wisconsin. Double wide to the right. Melvin Gordon to the right of McAvoy. And the handoff goes to Gordon straight ahead, and he is rolled down by Randy Gregory, shy of the 30-yard line. Gordon for the better part of five, depending on the spot. And they'll put it at the 30, so a gain of five, second down and five for Wisconsin.
They're going to have to find a way to neutralize Gregory a little bit here. He's had an impact already.
He's very active. They'll move him around in that defensive line. On the left edge right now with Greg McMullen on the right side. Double wide to the right. Second down and five for the Badgers. Stabby back at a quarterback. Hand off to Gordon. Breaking loose off the left side. He's to the 40. 45-50. 45-40. 35-30. And finally ran out of room. Inside the 30-yard line of Nebraska. They'll mark at the 28 as Gordon busts one here for the first time this afternoon.
Just a simple counterplay with Sam Arneson coming out and doing a great job. Physical, big-time kickout block to allow Gordon to bust that run.
Well, he covered up the safety number 25, Nate Gary, who's one of the better safeties in the Big Ten. He blasted him. The kickout up block, also credit goes to Derek Watt, the fullback, to create the running seam.
42-yard run for Gordon. McAvoy back in at quarterback on first and 10, and Corey Clement in the lineup. McAvoy fakes the handoff to him. Tanner breaking right to the 20. McAvoy to the 15, and he fumbled the football. It's loose inside the 10, and coming up with it is Wisconsin, and it's Melvin Gordon pouncing on the loose ball. Oh, the ball takes a favorable bounce for Wisconsin. Josh Mitchell, the corner, looked like he was ready to recover. He could not. Gordon does. And the Badgers have a first and goal as they are into the Case IH red zone. Get in the red zone, win with Case IH. Learn more about exclusive offers on top-performing tractors and combines at CaseIH.com.
The ball was almost on the ground on the mesh between the quarterback McAvoy and Clement.
Double wide to the left. Joel Stavi at a quarterback. Bubble screen left. Pass caught by Erickson on the catch. And he is brought down by Josh Mitchell right away as he does a good job of working through the block attempt of Jordan Frederick as Erickson chopped down at the line of scrimmage, which is the Nebraska 9, second and goal, Wisconsin.
What I loved about that recovery, Gordon was split wide out. He's blocking his guy, finishing it. And by his hustle, he goes down there and is in the position to make that recovery.
Corey Clement, the running back. Erickson wide to the right. Stavi stays in at quarterback. Sam Arneson, wing left, motions to the right. Stavi hands off to Clement. He's off the left side. He's hit at the line of scrimmage, and he gets nothing. There's Nebraska getting stubborn defensively. Greg McMullen getting in there, the defensive end, sophomore out of Akron, Ohio, 6'3", 280-pounder, third and goal Badgers at the Huskers 9 with 7 minutes left of the first quarter, 10-0 Nebraska.
Latasha was Nebraska's leading tackler who made the play by blowing up Arneson's block attempt. Zaire Anderson filled the gap.
Third and goal, Wisconsin at the Nebraska 9. Frederick wide left. Erickson slot left. Stavi in the shotgun. Gordon to the left of the QB. Frederick in motion left to right. Stavi takes the shotgun snap. Back to throw. Has some time. Now dances off to his right with Gregory in pursuit. Joel throwing, and the pass is caught by Arneson, but little gain on the play. In fact, maybe a half a yard at best, just inside the 9-yard line. So fourth down, the Badgers will send on the field goal team.
Again, Randy Gregory is in another position of flushing out Stavi. And we're going to keep harping on this. Third and long is not a situation that Wisconsin is going to have a ton of success at, and they're not going to want to be in that position. So they're going to need to be better on first and second down to not be in this position.
This will be a 26-yard field goal for Rafael Gaglianoni from the right hash mark. Gaglianoni has made 7 straight. Here's the snap, spot, kick is in the air, and the Badgers are on the board. Gaglianoni from 26 yards away, so Wisconsin gets 3 points back, and we have a break in the action.
Register for the virtual Crazy Legs Classic. Get a t-shirt and race bib, plus the first 2,500. Get a participant medal. Register at CrazyLegsClassic.com.
Preparation. It's the key to success on game day. And like your favorite Badgers on the field, you need to be ready right from the opening kickoff. Cenex has your pregame routine covered. We've got your salty snacks, your sweet treats, ice-cold beverages to wash them down, and fresh tanks of propane to fire up the grill. Fuel your fandom at your local Cenex station. Badger Pride, powered locally.
Buying your first home is the start of realizing bigger dreams with your family. That's why it's important to protect everything you love with American Family Insurance. Wait, what's that?
It's their dream car.
Oh, mm-hmm. Nice.
Yeah. It's actually my dream car. And my little dream tire swing with some dream trees. There'd be a nice dream garden right here, too.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly.
Some see a grilled cheese sandwich and ask why. I see a new kitchen with a grill and ask why not.
I really need to start adding less to cart and more to savings.
Sitting on this couch so long made me want to make some changes, starting with this couch.
Yeah, I need a house with a different view.
And this is the bank that will help you do it all. Because at U.S. Bank, our people are dedicated to turning your new inspiration into your next pursuit.
6:04 left first quarter, 10-3 Nebraska leads Wisconsin. The Huskers have a first and 10 at their own 23-yard line. Here, Abdullah, the running back. Early returns for him. Five carries, 31 yards. Two receivers right, one on the left. Armstrong under his center, Mark Pelini takes the snap, play fake. Armstrong rolling to his right, rolling, and now he'll tuck it and run to the 25, and he is rolled to the turf by Marcus Trotter at the 30-yard line of the Huskers. Armstrong on the roll, good for 7 yards, second down and three.
Well, they can definitely get the ball to the perimeter with Armstrong and Abdullah sort of leading interference, serving as a passing option.
Mentioned Armstrong can be physical if he needs to be. 6'1", 220 pounds, sophomore. He's very well put together. Two receivers right, one on the left. Abdullah, the running back, to the left of Armstrong in the shotgun. Pearsonell, wide right, motions left. They'll fake the fly sweep as Armstrong keeps it, gets tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. Good work by Joe Schobert. As Armstrong goes down at the 29, loss of one, Huskers have a third and four.
That's the best way to kind of slow this read option. You have to get penetration in the backfield so that they can't sit back and have all kinds of time to make these decisions. Make them quicker, they're not going to be as effective.
Nebraska with a third and four at its own 29-yard line. 5 minutes left, first quarter, 10-3, the Huskers. Two receivers right, two receivers left. Armstrong has Abdullah to his right. Westerkamp, slot right, motions to the left. Play clock is at 4, 3, 2, 1, and now the snap. Armstrong to throw. Looking, pumps, fires right side, incomplete. Intended for Kenny Bell. Good coverage from Sojourn Shelton near the 40 of the near side, and the Huskers are forced to punt.
Shelton jumping around a little bit, and rightly so. That was perfect coverage. Used his hands. They fought off each other there, Bell and Shelton Sojourn. Going to have to play Bell that way this afternoon.
Wisconsin decided to bring a little bit of pressure. Caputo, Nebraska actually did a nice job of checking out and making the adjustment to pick that up. It was a great job on the coverage to have Nebraska punt.
Sam Foltz will punt. Kenzel Doe deep at the Badger 37. Snap is clean. Foltz steps up. Pressure light. The kick is in the air, and he hangs it high. Fair catch signaled by Kenzel Doe, and he'll make it inside the 25. They'll mark it the 22 in Badger territory. 4:29 left in the first quarter. It is 10-3 Nebraska as we play on here at Camp Randall Stadium. That was a 48-yard punt for Sam Foltz. They'll place the ball. Actually, they'll inch it up a yard there. So at the 23 of Wisconsin, first and 10.
A couple of concerning things as a Badger fan. The turnover, obviously, has been something. The ball's been on the ground. But this field position, you figure it's going to be tough sledding picking up yards. Nebraska's had a short field and now just a nice 48-yard punt with no return.
Joel Stabby, the quarterback. Melvin Gordon, the running back. In the 23 in Wisconsin territory, first and 10. Hand off to Melvin, trying the right side, and he gets slammed down by linebacker Trevor Roach. Gordon with a hard yard to the 24, second down and 9.
Roach was one of the stars defensively for Nebraska at Michigan State. He had 18 tackles against the Spartans, including 4 TFLs.
He comes in third on the team in stops, 49 for the year. Second down and 9 for the Badgers at their own 24-yard line. Melvin Gordon will come out wide to the left. Erickson slot left. Tanner McAvoy now the quarterback. And McAvoy's going to keep it, trying to right side to the 25-yard line, up across the 30. Goes Tanner McAvoy to the 31, the straight run from the quarterback. It's about 7. Santos, David Santos, a linebacker on the stop, and the Badgers looking at a 3rd and 2 from their own 31.
It's going to be interesting after the first quarter if Andy Ludwig just takes a look back on what happened with these two quarterbacks and determines maybe who might have the most success today operating against this defense.
Maybe they just keep tagging off the way they have in his first quarter. Stabby back in there now from the 31 of Wisconsin. High formation behind him. Joel takes the snap. Hand off Gordon. Off the left side. He gets covered up. Corey Cooper, the safety, coming up into the box. The ball popped out, and Nebraska recovers. So the Badgers put it on the turf again, as that was Cooper and Zaire Anderson digging it out of there. So Anderson with a couple of fumble recoveries in this first quarter. And the Huskers have it at the Badger 30-yard line. Oh, my goodness.
That was a case there. Nebraska brought pressure off the edge, got basically just swallowed up the hole and not allowing any room for Gordon. And then there's all kinds of Nebraska defenders swiping at the ball. And another turnover here and another short field for Nebraska to try to capitalize.
Someone hit the ball before Cooper got there.
Yeah, Costigan did. He was tangled up with one of the linebackers, I believe, for Nebraska. And then Gordon brushed Costigan. The ball started to come out. Here's the fake handoff. He's keeping it as Armstrong after faking the handoff to Abdullah. Armstrong straight ahead for a couple. Vince Beagle wrapped him up at the 28-yard line of Wisconsin. Gain of 2, 2nd and 8, 2:50 left of the first quarter. 10-3 Nebraska.
Beagle played it perfectly, just held his ground and waited for him to make the move, and then he attacked him.
Two receivers right, one on the left. Abdullah behind Armstrong now. Second down and 8 for the Badger 28. Hand off Amir Abdullah off the left side. Inside the 25, still up and down to about the 20-yard line. Oh, he's busting some tackles here. Amir Abdullah in the first quarter, and they will mark it just shy of the 20-yard line. Trotter, Marcus Trotter, and Derek Landish in on the stop. Third down, about a half a yard to go, just outside the 20-yard line of Wisconsin.
Yeah, Akeem Hunt went down with that tackle last week by Peniel Jean. Not today with Abdullah.
Yeah, and Akeem Hunt's not bad either, but Abdullah's just special.
Yeah, just different
special
level.
Kenny Bell wide to the right. Janovich the fullback, Abdullah the tailback. Armstrong under his center, Mark Pelini takes the snap, gives to Abdullah, gets the first down, crashing over the right side. He was cut down by Michael Caputo inside the 20 to about the 17 of Wisconsin. First down for the Huskers. They lead the Badgers 10-3 with a minute 47 left of the first quarter. Nebraska has had the field tilted very much in its favor in the first quarter, leading by 7 and looking to extend it. Here late in quarter number 1, 2 receivers right, 1 on the left. Bell wide left, motions right. Armstrong leads it and keeps it, running left to the 15, and Armstrong taken down by Marcus Trotter at the 10-yard line of Wisconsin. Gain of 7, 2nd and 3.
The read option puts so much pressure on the outside defensive linebacker to make a decision. What is he going to do? And if they're good at it, it makes it that much tougher. That's why the penetration from inside makes everybody else's read a lot clearer on the defensive side. Right now, that was not a good example of that.
Pearson L wide to the right. Bell slot right. Janovich the fullback to the left of Armstrong. Abdullah behind the quarterback. The Badger 10-yard line, 2nd and 3 for the Huskers. Hand off Abdullah trying the left side. Marcus Trotter closed the gate. And then he gets some help. No gain, maybe a slight loss on the play. Third down, a little more than 3 to go. No, Mark, we'll call it the 10, 3rd and 3, Nebraska, with 38 seconds and counting left in the first quarter. Crowd trying to get into it and help the defense here. Two receivers right, one on the left. 3rd and 3, Nebraska at the Badger 10-yard line. Little look over to the bench as Armstrong calls for the ball, takes the snap. Little option to the right. He'll fake the toss. He'll keep it. Armstrong needs the 7, and that's about where he gets. The 7-yard line of Wisconsin. There's a little fake on the toss. Caputo over there defensively for the Badgers. And it's a 1st and goal, Nebraska, at the Badgers 7-yard line.
It's a good short yardage play, speed option.
4 seconds left, time winding down here in the first quarter, and Nebraska will have to try to finish this drive into the student section at the north end zone as we hit the end of quarter number 1.
Badger fans, your team is always working to perform at their highest level, even with the physical stress throughout the season. This is made possible with on-site treatment and recovery, courtesy of the Mueller Sports Medicine Recovery Tent. Mueller Sports Medicine is a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Built in sport, made for life. Mueller.
Hard work, sweat, knowledge, and your own two hands. These are the tools that build Wisconsin. Leave your mark on the real world with zero debt and higher pay. All from day one. It's time to do work that works for you. Learn more at buildingwisconsintogether.com.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep.
just direct your feet on the sunny side, the sunny side of the street.
My favorite breakfast is Odyssey yogurt. I asked Mommy where it comes from, and she took me to a dairy farm to learn all about milk and, most importantly, cows. Wisconsin cows are definitely the happiest, which means they make the tastiest yogurt. My favorite is blueberry. What's your flavor? Support your local farmers. EIEI Odyssey.
Huskers now moving to the north, and that's to our left. First and goal, Nebraska at the Badgers' 7-yard line. Armstrong will work under center. Andy Janovich, the fullback. Behind him is Amir Abdullah. Bell wide right, motions left. Hand off Abdullah, straight ahead, lowers the pads, gets to the 5. Jake Kiefer there for Wisconsin. Gain of 2, second and goal for the Huskers. Off the Badger 5-yard line as we just get started here in the second quarter in Madison. Armstrong looking over. Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator for the Huskers. Trips to the left. Abdullah behind Armstrong, and now Amir will shift to the right of the quarterback. Second and goal at the Badger 5-yard line. Play clock is at 7. Abdullah checking off. Play clock at 3. At 2. Here's the snap. Abdullah running left inside the 5. Make that Armstrong running left inside the 5 into the end zone. Touchdown, Nebraska. Even I even get too locked into Amir Abdullah and Tommy Armstrong. Slanting left, and he goes in untouched, and it's 16-3, the Huskers.
It's a matter of just counting where the defenders are and running away from them. Wisconsin overloaded one side of the formation, blitzed up the middle, and Armstrong just took it to the opposite side of the formation where there were fewer defenders and more blockers.
Pretty easy money there for Tommy Armstrong with a 5-yard touchdown run. Drew Brown on to attempt the extra point. 16-3, Nebraska. And the extra point is in the air, and it is good. The home team has some work to do.
The Wisconsin Department of Transportation reminds you to always drive sober. Zero in Wisconsin. Together, we can save lives. Get the Drive Sober app today.
We believe in education. We believe in public schools. At WEA Member Benefits, we believe in helping Wisconsin public school employees and their families achieve their financial goals by providing personal insurance, retirement and investment, and financial planning programs that are designed specifically for the education community. WEABenefits.com.
Hey Badger fans, Matt's Matt for Brewpub Lots of Matzah Pizzas. Absolutely loving these Dream Season Badger games from back in the day. Hey, speaking of back in the day, remember when frozen pizzas were like a piece of cardboard laden with a flavorless sauce, topped with ingredients you'd reach after 5 bites, then sparsely decorated with cheese? Well, not anymore. Brewpub Lots of Matzah Pizzas came along and were a game changer. A crispy, thin cracker crust topped with a bold sauce, loaded with quality meat and veggie toppings, then bombarded with over 1/2 pound of award-winning mozzarella cheese. Brewpub Pizzas, the perfect pizza, no matter the season.
Points off of the Wisconsin turnovers, a field goal in the first quarter, a fumble recovered at the Badger 29, and then a touchdown here early in the second, and a fumble recovered late in the first quarter at the Badger 30. Laurel Bondi with a kick in the air, steers it to Kenzel Bell. He'll catch at the goal line, right side to the 5, faking the reverse, 10, 15 across the 20, and Doe is cut down shy of the 25-yard line. They fake that reverse to Melvin Gordon, we might add. And Nebraska not taking the bait. The Badgers will be starting at their 23, first and 10.
Well, Joel Stavies attempted 4 passes in this game, completed 2 for 1 yard. 1 yard. I'm not sure they can block for him or how long they can block for him. That'll be an ongoing question.
It'll be Stabby's show, at least for this play, and we have seen, just like last week, within a series of downs, both Stabby and McAvoy. Erickson comes out wide to the left. Jordan Frederick slot to the left. Derek Watt the fullback, Gordon the tailback. The Badger 23-yard line. Wisconsin going left to right in quarter two. Hand off Gordon over right guard. Just a couple. Zaire Anderson getting in there defensively for the Huskers. Gain of two to the Badger 25, second down and eight.
Not a ton of push. Costigan got pushed back a little bit there. A lot, not giving much room for Gordon to push there. And that's when you're playing against better players, giving up a little bit of an edge, you're not going to have the same success if you're playing against talent like Nebraska has on their front.
McAvoy now in at quarterback. Erickson wide left, no slot left. Gordon to the left of Tanner McAvoy on second down. Tanner reads it, and he'll hand off to Gordon trying the right side, and he'll get just a yard as Nebraska gangs up on him. Malik Collins, Randy Gregory getting involved, as well as Greg McMillan. All defensive linemen, a couple of yards to the 27. The Badgers now have a third and six.
My question, and has been some time now, do they predetermine the handoff on that play? Because if he was reading it, he would have probably kept the ball.
Yeah, at first I thought he did. That's why I said he read it, but I think maybe the answer is no. That was, he was just going to go hand it to him on that play. Now Stavi in a quarterback, four receivers to either side. Stavi in the gun, Gordon to his right. Third and six for the Badgers at their own 27-yard line. Stavi takes the shotgun snap, little pressure up the middle. Stavi gets drilled as he throws right side, and it's caught by Jordan Frederick at the 38-yard line. Daniel Davey on the coverage. Boy, Stavi took a shot. Zaire Anderson coming in on Stavi, who threw a dart to Frederick, and that is a big play. First down Badgers at the 38-yard line.
Stavi needs some time here, a standing eight count.
Yeah, that would have been a good time to tag out. Give McAvoy a play. Yeah, Badger's going to take a timeout here as Gary Anderson asking for and receiving a timeout with 12:32 left in the first half. That's a big play, not in yards gained. It was enough for a first down, but it just maybe gives that offense a chance to get a little rhythm going here. 12:32 left in the half, 17-3 Nebraska.
We've missed you. Wisconsin football season tickets are now available. For details, visit uwbadgers.com.
As a Wisconsin Badgers football fan, you probably know a thing or two about consistent, top-quality performance. Hi, I'm Gary Leeper, General Manager at Dairyland Seed. And for over 110 years, we've been delivering nothing but the industry's best seed designed to deliver higher yields and unmatched quality to farmers in all environments and conditions. So just as you can bet on Bucky dominating the ground game, you can count on Dairyland Seed to be your most valuable partner each and every season. Dairyland Seed, proud sponsor of Wisconsin football and Wisconsin farmers.
On this game day, Good Foods Guacamole would like to salute all you players, no matter what you seem to be playing. You, sir, are a winner. You, ma'am, triumphant, and thumbs up to whatever it is you're doing. So let's hoist a guac-laden chip to all you players out there. Good Foods Guac, made from the freshest avocado and the cleanest ingredients. So here's to all the players and whatever game it is they're trying to play. Game day is guac day. Good Foods Guac.
Because of this, we made Ford Super Duty the most capable heavy-duty pickup ever. Because of this, we built Ford F-150 with 375 horsepower and best-in-class payload.
Rescue 614 inbound.
Because of this, we built Ford Ranger with the terrain management system. And because Ford trucks are built for this, you made Ford America's best-selling brand.
Zeldo comes out wide to the left. Alex Erickson to the right. Stavi under his center, Dan Volz. Watt and Gordon, the backfield combo. Stavi on first down. Hand off Gordon. Off the right side, has space. 45-50, 45-40, 35-30. Still up and gone. 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Melvin Gordon. 62 yards. Just a little hurdle over Corey Cooper, and Gordon was long gone.
A big smile on Mark Tauscher's face because it was the right tackle who threw the key block to spring Gordon to the boundary, and that was Robbie Havenstein.
It was a great block, but to seal the edge, but what an outstanding effort by a super football player to make it the extra yard, to make that hurdle to take it into the end zone. Just sheer athleticism by Melvin Gordon.
I believe they will review this to make sure Gordon stayed in bounds, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Replay official Tom Fiedler here this afternoon. And the question is, was Melvin able to tightrope that sideline in front of the Badger bench? If it stands, it's a 62-yard run. There's Melvin Gordon, who popped a long run in the first quarter. That's going to stand. He's fine. This will not take long. 9 carries, 115 yards for Melvin Gordon. We'll get the official word right now.
After further review, the ruling on the field of touchdown is confirmed.
9 carries, 115, and now a touchdown for Melvin Gordon. 17-9 Nebraska. Rafael Gaglianone on to attempt the extra point. The Badgers try to pull within 7 early in quarter number 2. And the kick is in the air, and the kick is good. 12-21 left in quarter 2. We'll keep it here. Nebraska 17, Wisconsin 10.
One of the reasons that opened up so widely for Gordon beyond the block by Havenstein is that Alex Erickson, the right wide receiver to that side of the formation, ran a route inside, and Daniel Davey went with him and slipped. So Davey took himself out of position. He's the corner to that side of the field, and that's why Gordon had so much room to run.
I was wondering why on the telecast here Bo Pelini was getting after him, and that something happened. That was greatly blocked, but the explosion to get to the corner and then the athleticism to take it from the 30 in when he should have gotten pushed out of bounds, that's what you expect from your big-time player in a situation where you really needed it.
And he sure did. Let's see if that turns the momentum here as Wisconsin gets into the end zone for the first time today. 17-10 Nebraska. Andrew Endicott will kick off for Wisconsin. DeMornay Pearson-L and Kenny Bell are deep for the Huskers. Endicott on the run-up, and the kick is in the air, and he hit this one well. Going back is Kenny Bell, yard deep, coming out left side 5 to the 10, 15, Bell to the 20, Bell to the 25-yard line, and just across the 25. And he is stopped there. Leon Jacobs in kick coverage for Wisconsin. Carter tight end, motions left to right. Abdullah the running back, 9 carries. He has 44 yards so far today. And keeping it as Armstrong across the 25-yard line, and he is wrapped up by Derek Landish at about the 28. Armstrong keeps it and gets 3 on the play. 2nd and 7 coming up for the Huskers.
Well, Beagle did the right thing. Grab somebody. Don't let him run past you, and he grabbed Abdullah. Hit him. Make him feel it.
And as I said, it wasn't snowing. It is starting to very lightly right now. Camp Randall. 2nd and 7, Nebraska at its own 28-yard line. 11:42 left in the half, 17-10, Nebraska. Bell wide right, motions to the left. Armstrong takes the shotgun snap, rolling to his left. Looks, fires left side, off the mark. Wanted Pearson-L near midfield on the near side. Sojourn Shelton on the coverage. Pass off the mark, and it's 3rd and 7 Nebraska at its own 28.
Now the freshman Pearson-L ran a different route than Armstrong anticipated. He took it a little bit deeper than he wanted to.
Crowd getting a little cranked up now. 3rd down and 7 Nebraska, the Huskers 28-yard line. Jordan Westerkamp along with DeMornay Pearson-L and Kenny Bell out to the left. Play clock is at 10. The Huskers get organized at the line of scrimmage. Play clock at 5. Abdullah to the right of the QB. Armstrong takes the snap. Little pressure coming. Armstrong throws to the left. Incomplete. Kenny Bell, the intended receiver at the 40. Shelton again on the coverage. And Nebraska's forced to punt.
You can tell Shelton's into this game. It's just the way he's handling Kenny Bell. And that's one of the better receivers in this league. And there's a different vibe to Shelton today than we've seen thus far this year.
Sam Foltz back to punt, line of scrimmage. The Huskers 28. Kenzel Doe deep at the Wisconsin 38. And The snap high, but Foltz pulls it down. Little roll to the right, and the kick is in the air. Kenzel Doe, another fair catch. He'll make it inside the 30-yard line. Good work by the punter of handling a snap that was a bit upstairs, and we have a break in the action.
Hey there, Badgers. Good Foods Guacamole would like to celebrate all you fans, so let's hoist a guac-laden chip to the Badgers, because game day is guac day. Visit goodfoods.com to learn more, and be sure to like on Facebook and follow on Instagram at Good Foods.
In these challenging, uncertain, uncharted times, you stand strong. No matter the conditions you face, you get the job done. You are the backbone of our communities.
Sleek, innovative, efficient. If it looks like next-gen technology, that's because it is. Introducing new Infinity products with GreenSpeed intelligence from Carrier. They deliver leading efficiency and can even receive over-the-air updates, just like your smartphone. Now you can keep your heating and cooling software up to date for enhanced performance. It's space-age innovation, all designed for your space. Carrier. Turn to the experts.
Rocket drive block?
Rush a soul crush?
Jam a grand slam? Drunk? Drunk?
That'd be insane!
Roll in that?
Roll in this?
Roll together? Drunk?
That would be super insane!
Hey, all you ladies and guys.
Drive sober on the road.
No matter how many wheels you roll.
Joel Stavi, the quarterback, double wide to the right. Melvin Gordon, the lone running back. Kenzel Doe, slot right, motions left. They'll fake the fly sweep, toss right. Here's Melvin Gordon across the 30, shakes to the 35, and Josh Mitchell wrapped him up at the 37-yard line. Gordon, 8 more yards. He now has 123 on 10 carries.
Nice job there by Dan Volts, the center. Just a little misdirection, fake out left. Pitched the ball to Gordon. Volts pulled right and did a nice job of getting the middle linebacker's legs down on the ground and allowing him to pick up a couple extra yards.
Second down and two for the Badgers at their 37-yard line. Sam Arneson and Alex Erickson out to the left. Arneson motions to the formation, eye backs behind Stavi. And off Gordon, off the right side. He'll lower the pads and get the first down to the 40-yard line. David Santos on the tackle for Nebraska. Gain of 3 and a first down for Wisconsin at its own 40-yard line.
That run on first down, that was a new play that they put in for this game. It's a play that I always used to ask Paul Chris to run because it's a pro variation. You see it in the pros all the time where that flick misdirection, get the ball to the perimeter as quickly as possible.
Did you charge him for that advice?
Paul didn't listen to me. Yeah. He never ran the play.
He always went up to him, Mike, what should I run this week?
Yeah, he asked me first.
Double wide to the left. Melvin Gordon, the running back. Bubble screen left. Caught by Kenzel Doe to the 40. Doe is slammed down by Corey Cooper at the 43-yard line of the far side. Gain of 3. Second down and 7 for Wisconsin. 10:08 left in the first half. 17-10. Nebraska leads Wisconsin.
Alex Erickson did what he could to kind of shield Josh Mitchell, keep him out of the play, and he accomplished what he wanted to do.
George Rushing, freshman receivers, he's out of Miramar, Florida, checks into the lineup, comes out wide to the left. Stavi under his center, Dan Volts. Rushing in motion left to right. No fly sweep to Rushing. Hand off Gordon straight ahead to the 45. Cuts left 50. Gordon to the 45. And Davey wrestles him down. And the ball comes out again at the 41-yard line. Nebraska claiming it has it. And it does. Melvin Gordon loses his second fumble of the game. And I think it was Davey who knocked it out. As the officials were pointing Nebraska's way.
I'd like to see the replay on that and whether or not they're
going to get down.
Yeah, that'd be my question. That's what I would like to see. Davey was riding. He was actually riding Melvin Gordon, and I'm not sure if he was down or not. We'll get a look.
Take a look at the replay right now. That was popped out. I think
it was Nate Gary. Yep.
Gary popped it out. That's going to be Nebraska football. I mean, they're not reviewing it yet. Now they are, but I'm pretty sure this is going to go the other way.
That's just that looked like a pretty good play by the 25, Nate Gary.
Yeah, that's out. 9:42 left in the half. It is 17-10, Nebraska.
Where is his knee? Is his knee down before the ball comes out? That's the question.
From what I'm looking at,
pretty close, isn't it?
It is close, but I don't think it's going to be enough to overturn it. Oh, Tosh, what do you think?
I'm going to go because it's in Madison, and Mike was just kind of talking about how some of these calls, I think his knee was down, and I'm going to say Wisconsin ball.
It's Razor's Edge. Let's check in with Patrick.
I'll say this. Melvin Gordon has his helmet off and is sitting down on the bench, and his teammates just came around him and said, get back up. We might get this ball back. One byproduct of it being so cold, and it's about 25 degrees right now, is that the ball is very hard and very slick. Mark, I'm sure you can attest to this and what this weather does to the ball.
Here's a call.
Recovered by Nebraska is confirmed.
Yep, Nebraska ball. The crowd, as you would imagine, isn't going to like it, but I think the proper call is made.
I think you're probably right in the fact that it was really a razor's edge call, as you put it, and if it was the other way, I think it would have probably stayed both sides. It was nip and tuck, and that's, you keep putting the ball on the turf, it really makes it tough to win a football game.
And they say confirmed, and that means that to the replay judge, that was clear that it was out. First down at the 41 of Nebraska. Fourth fumble and the third lost fumble of the day for Wisconsin. Here's the handoff. Abdullah right side to the 45-yard line. Amir Abdullah near the 49 of Nebraska. Schobert along with Caputo in on the tackle. That's a gain of about 7 for Amir Abdullah. Let's see where they place it. Yep, at the 48 of Nebraska.
The irony is that Nebraska's lost 56 fumbles since the 2011 season.
And it's Wisconsin putting it on the ground here today. Amani Cross now, the running back. Second down and 3 for the Huskers at their own 48-yard line. Armstrong will give it to Amani Cross over the right side. It gets across midfield into Wisconsin territory. And that's very close to the first down. And I believe it will be Trotter on the stop for Wisconsin. First down, Huskers at the Badger 48-yard line.
Kind of an important possession for the defense just to show it can handle some sudden change. It's had enough opportunities here in the first half.
9 minutes left in this first half, 17-10 Nebraska. Cross stays in the game. Four receivers, two either way. Westerkamp slot right, motions to the left. Armstrong. They'll give it to Amani Cross, and he is chopped down near the 45 of Wisconsin. Marcus Trotter getting in there. Gain of 3, 2nd and 7. The Huskers get right back on the ball. Terrell Newby will come in at running back now, replacing Cross. Abdullah, by the way, 10 carries, 51 yards so far in this first half. Gordon with 12 for 142 and a touchdown, but he has lost 2 fumbles. Three receivers left, one on the right. Second down and 7, Nebraska. Line of scrimmage, the Wisconsin 45-yard line. Newby moves to the left of Armstrong. The play clock at 3. And the handoff goes to Terrell Newby, and the ball popped out. And the Badgers say they have it, and they do. Near their 45-yard line, Schobert comes out of there for the home team.
And it's Warren Herring with the hit. The forced fumble by Wisconsin's fifth-year senior nose guard, Warren Herring.
That's really what you're looking for from your best players. That obviously the defense needed a stop there, and with all of the turnovers, Herring did a great job of beating him across the face, getting the ball out. I'm not sure who recovered it, but that is a big-time play by Warren Herring.
Well, Gary Anderson on the radio show Thursday night, Mike, if you haven't mentioned this already, Gary was saying when it gets 30 degrees or colder, it changes. You know, how the feel of the football and all of that. And maybe that has something to do with it. Badgers at their own 44-yard line, 1st and 10. Stavi, the quarterback. Watt and Gordon, the backfield combo. Here comes Melvin over the right side. Nothing at the point of attack. Bounces right. Now he has room. 50, 45, 40, 35, 30. Gordon to the 20. Gordon inside the 20 and down to the 17-yard line. Nate Gary on the tackle as Melvin Gordon with an electrifying moment. Nothing at all at the point of attack. He made it a big play.
Number 5, Josh Mitchell, is the best defender, best defensive back for Nebraska. And he stutter steps Mitchell into infamy.
He definitely didn't look like it on that play. What another just great show of athleticism by Gordon to not only make that miss, then to pick up another 15, 20 yards. Just a great run again.
39-yard run. Badgers into the Case IH red zone at the Nebraska 17-yard line, first and 10. And here comes Corey Clement over the right side to the 15. Clement to the 10. Clement to the 5. Clement to the end zone. Touchdown, Wisconsin. 17-yard run, and it's a 17-16 game. Badgers trying to tie it with the PAT.
Clement was not going to be denied the end zone. He took advantage of blocks from his fullback, Derek Watt, and again his right tackle, Rob Havenstein.
That's the good news is he scored. The bad news is Clement is still down, and he is in pain. A physical run from Corey Clement, but it has a price. As the athletic trainers are tending to Corey Clement, and that will cause a little stoppage here before the Badgers line up for the extra point. 17-16, Nebraska, 7:21 left in the first half. And now Corey gets up and
jogs off. Did he fall on the ball? I didn't see the end of the play.
He was favoring his right arm. But they'll continue to take a look at him over on the sideline, the athletic trainers. Rafael Gaglianone on for the extra point. Kick is in the air, and this game is tied.
You don't have to be a scientist to work at Exact Sciences. Visit exactsciences.com to view the company's hundreds of open jobs and join the fight against cancer.
Buying your first home is the start of realizing bigger dreams with your family. That's why it's important to protect everything you love with American Family Insurance. Wait, what's that?
It's their dream car.
Oh, Nice.
Yeah, it's actually my dream car. And my little dream tire swing with some dream trees. There'd be a nice dream garden right here, too.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance.
Insure carefully, dream fearlessly.
University of Wisconsin Carbone Cancer Center, providing cancer research, education, and treatment for people throughout Wisconsin and Northern Illinois. Information at uwhealth.org/cancer. UW Health, providing specialty and primary care for all ages throughout Wisconsin. Information on UW Health physicians and clinics and on University of Wisconsin Hospital, available on the web at uwhealth.org.
On this game day, Good Foods Guacamole would like to salute all you players, no matter what you seem to be playing. You, sir, are a winner. You, ma'am, triumphant, and thumbs up to whatever it is you're doing. So let's hoist a guac-laden chip to all you players out there. Good Foods Guac, made from the freshest avocado and the cleanest ingredients. So here's to all the players and whatever game it is they're trying to play. Game day is guac day. Good Foods Guac.
DeMornay Pearson L, Kenny Bell deep for the Huskers as Andrew Endicott ready to kick off. The approach and the kick in the air. And this will be Kenny Bell at the 2 between the hash marks, 5 to the 10. Bell 15 up the middle to the 20. And the Badgers crash down on him just beyond the 20-yard line to about the 22. Austin Hudson down there among others in kick coverage for Wisconsin. Leo Musso really leading the way. That's a Nebraska coughing it up. Coming into the game, it had fumbled 19 times, losing 7. Last year, they fumbled 32 times and lost half of them. First and 10, Nebraska from its own 22. Two receivers left, one on the right. Amir Abdullah back in the game to the right of the quarterback. And Armstrong will give it to him, and play is whistled down. Penalty markers fly before the snap.
Movement on the offensive line. Badgers on defense now calling for the crowd to stay in it.
First and 15, Nebraska from its own 17. Nebraska led 17-3, but the Badgers now punch back. 62-yard run from Melvin Gordon. 17-yard scoring run moments ago from Corey Clement. Four receivers, two either way. Abdullah to the left of Armstrong. the Nebraska 17-yard line, first and 15. And a handoff to Abdullah running right across the 20-yard line and up to the 25 goes Amir Abdullah. Marcus Trotter able to pull him down at the 25-yard line on a gain of 8, second and 7 for the Huskers. Honestly, that was Landish, I think, on the stop, and not Trotter.
I'll say this. Anybody that was questioning if Abdullah was healthy, he looks fresh. I know they're limiting him a little bit, but he looks fresh and is finishing his runs very nicely.
Abdullah stays in the game behind Tommy Armstrong. Second down and 7 for the Huskers at their own 25-yard line. Play clock at 7. Now Abdullah moves to the right of Armstrong. Takes the knee-high snap. Armstrong to throw. Backside pressure. Throws left side, and it is incomplete. Wanted Riley at the 45-yard line of the near side. Devin Golden on the coverage. And it's third down and 7 for Nebraska at the Huskers 25.
It almost begged for a run there. The Badgers were in their nickel package, and they elected to throw.
They stay nickel now on third down and 7. Actually, it's a dime. Three receivers left, one on the right. Rolling left is Armstrong. Looking, throwing, and it's knocked away. Batted down. Incomplete. Schobert getting the pull up there, and Nebraska is forced to punt.
This might sound strange to some people who are just looking at the score, but the defense has really played exceptionally well in this half. All things considered, mainly the field position, the short fields that Nebraska has been operating on.
Yeah, 10 of their points coming off of turnovers, one at the Badger 29, another at the 30 of Wisconsin. And Joe Schobert just rejecting that pass attempt. And Nebraska punting from its own 25-yard line. Fultz on the punt. Snap clean. Badgers get pressure, and the kick is away. And Kenzel Doe has to let it sail over his head. It hits inside the 30 of Wisconsin on the far sideline, and it'll go out of bounds at the Badger 25. 6:09 left in the first half. Nebraska 17, Wisconsin 17.
Well, what's happened when they've been in down and distance situations that have favored the defense, Armstrong has been unable to make that key pass. He's 1 of 8 here in the first half.
It's something we talked about leading into the game. You really, from Wisconsin's side, you want to stay normal third down. Same thing on defense. You want to put Armstrong in a tough position where he has to throw the football. Make both quarterbacks throw the football. Whoever's going to be able to do it best is going to win the game.
Three receivers to the right. Stavi, the quarterback. Melvin Gordon, the running back. Sam Arneson motions to the formation. On first down, handoff. Gordon gets a block from Arneson. 30, cuts left. Gordon, 40. Outside the numbers, 50. To the 45, to the 40. To the 35, and out of bounds at the 32-yard line of Nebraska. Oh, a crushing block from Sam Arneson, helping spring Gordon. Bill Mark at the 31 of the Huskers.
We had some other helpers out there, too. Austin Traylor for one. We haven't called his name many times, but when they're getting the ball to the perimeter and having success, more often than not, Traylor's helping out.
44-yard run, another big run for Gordon. First down, Wisconsin at the 31 of Nebraska. Rushing wide left, motions right, and the handoff to Melvin Gordon inside the 30, inside the 25, and down to the 22 of Nebraska. Nate Gary, the safety on the tackle. And that's a gain of close, well, we'll call it 9 to the 22 of Nebraska's second and 1.
Gordon has been getting a lot of yards on his own today, but that was outstanding job. Llewellyn, Meritz on the combination backside shoved him. That was a case where that yardage was blocked for him.
We have 5:10 left in the first half, and Melvin Gordon has 234 rushing yards on 15 totes. Erickson wide left, Doe to the right, and now Stavi rolling to the right, looking, shoots at the Kenzel Doe, who makes the catch inside the 10-yard line of the near side. Out of bounds goes Doe, just inside the 10, first and goal, Wisconsin.
Well, I like the fact that they rolled Stavi out to his right, buying him enough time to allow Doe to get inside leverage and position on his route.
Badgers back into the Case IH red zone.
My question would be, is Corey Clement going to be available? Melvin Gordon looks a little bit gassed after all the runs he's had. I'm serious. That's a question you have to ask. Is he going to have a relief today?
And Gary Anderson letting the play clock wind down, maybe trying to buy some time for Melvin Gordon.
Craving news on Wisconsin spring football? Stay tuned at halftime for an exclusive spring football report and the latest news from Wisconsin athletics.
Rocket drive block? Rush a pole crush? Jam a grand slam? Drunk? That'd be insane! Rolling that? Rolling this? Roll together? Drunk?
That would be super insane!
Hey, all you ladies and guys. Drive sober on the road.
No matter how many wheels you roll.
Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, whenever you want, in your life and on your farm, Case IH AFS Connect gives you more control. Monitor your operation, manage your fleet and your farm data your way. Case IH, rethink productivity.
Right now, Melvin Gordon has been more than nice. 15 carries, 234 yards. We still have 4:27 left in the half. Watt and Gordon, the backfield combo. Erickson wide right, motions to the left. Play fake, Stavi rolling to his right, looking, throwing. Derek Watt, and as he gathered it? No, he did not. Incomplete at the 5-yard line of the near side. Santos on the coverage. Derek juggling it, could not gather, and it's second and goal, Wisconsin at the Nebraska 9. 17 all late in the first half here in Madison. Stabby now 5 of 8 through the air for 28 yards. Watt and Gordon again offset. Alex Erickson wide left. Arneson wing on the left side. And here's a give to Melvin Gordon. He cuts to his left and he is chopped down at the 5-yard line. There's Corey Cooper on the tackle. Third and goal from the Nebraska 5. Gordon running for 4 on that play.
Get a nice job by the left side of the offensive line. Llewellyn, Merritts did a good job there. The tight ends filled that nicely. That was just a nice, hard, physical 4 or 5 yard run there by Gordon.
Stavi stays in at QB. Jordan Frederick out wide to the left. They're shifting with the tight ends. Fumagalli wing on the right. Arneson now tight to the left. Fumagalli motions right to left. Stavi in the gun. Gordon to his right. Stavi back to throw. Looking. Throws. In zone. Arneson got it. No signal yet as they drive it back. There's the signal. Touchdown, Wisconsin. Just breaking the plane to the goal line. Sam Arneson on the receiving end. Nate Gary tried to drive him back. He could not, and the Badgers take the lead.
They're going to have to take a look at this too, aren't they?
I'm sure they will. But they're not yet. 23-17, Wisconsin.
Well, that was tight quarters for Stabby's throw.
Pretty good goal line angle there from ABC, and like Sam is in. And they are not reviewing. Lines are set. Gaglianoni with the extra point attempt. And it is good. Well, the Badgers storming back. They trailed 17-3 early in the second quarter. We now have 3:31 left in this second quarter. We'll continue to hold it here. Wisconsin 24, Nebraska 17.
Well, Arneson's a big target. He presented himself to Stave. Just a quick turnaround in the end zone. Measured his steps, knew where he needed to be. Didn't have a whole lot of room to spare where he caught the ball, but hung on to it. I think that's why the official was waiting to see if he went through the process of the catch before signaling a touchdown.
And Nebraska obviously knew that was a play that Wisconsin was looking. Double coverage and just a, you know, we talk a lot about some of the inefficiencies of Stabby. That was a nice high throw, only where he could catch it. And nicely done to pick up 7 rather than 3. Big momentum boost for Wisconsin.
Small window, very small window, and Stabby was able to fit it in there.
24-17, Wisconsin in a wild first half here at Camp Randall Stadium. And still 3.5 minutes left in this first half.
Boy, think of the hill that this team has climbed. to overcome all those turnovers early on.
Is that a book plug?
I was just going to say, is that, did you co-write Bo's book? Bump them sales up a little bit?
If you'd like to promote it, go right ahead.
That check's still in the mail somewhere. Here's a kick in the air from Andrew Endicott. Kenny Bell at the three. He is to the 5, 10, 15, across the 20, up the left hash mark, 25-yard line. Kenny Bell fights his way to about the 26. Two receivers right, one on the left. Armstrong in the gun as Abdullah to his left from the 26 of Nebraska, first and 10. Huskers still have two timeouts available. They're going to have to use one of them now as the play clock was winding down. So now both teams down to one timeout left in this first half of play. Three receivers right, one on the left from the 26 of Nebraska, first and 10. Armstrong's going to keep it, works to his left, cuts it up across the 30-yard line, and Caputo chops him down. Armstrong for about four, and the clock is running with 3:10 left in the half. Second down, we'll call it five as they inch it up close to the 31-yard line, Nebraska territory. Second and five plus change. 24-17, the Badgers with 3 minutes left in the half. Pistol formation. The play clock still at 15. Armstrong surveys, takes the snap. He'll give it to Abdullah, running left, hit right away. He'll get a couple of yards. Marcus Trotter on the stop for Wisconsin. Gain of three for Abdullah to the 33 of the Huskers. Third and three, Nebraska.
Marcus Trotter is the ringleader of the Chevy Bad Boys. That's what they call themselves, the linebackers, inside and out.
Well, he's really putting together a good year. The senior out of Racine, Marcus Trotter. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Armstrong, back to throw. Badgers bringing pressure. Down goes Armstrong. Oh, my goodness. Storming in, Wisconsin bringing the pressure, and it is Marcus Trotter getting to Armstrong, and that's a Novo Nordisk sack worth $100 to the American Diabetes Association of Wisconsin.
Thing about Armstrong, he's 220 pounds. Marcus Trotter took him high and was able to throw him down like a gunny sack.
Just a simple, just basically dogged both linebackers, and Landish was waiting to see if the running back was going to go down a route. Trotter just came flying in there, and like Mike said, that it's not easy to get a quarterback down, especially one of the caliber of Armstrong, and to do it full speed like that, great athleticism.
Back, Kenzel Doe near midfield. Single safety for Wisconsin. Roll to the right. Now Fultz is going to keep it on the fake. 20 right side, 25, 30. 35-yard line, first down, Nebraska. Oh, there's a roll of the dice. Fourth and 11, deep in their own territory, and they execute the fake, and a penalty marker flies at the end of the play. It was fourth and 11 from the Huskers' 25-yard line, and Nebraska pulls off a fake punt. Here's a call
after
the penalty.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 72 on the offense. The line to gain had been achieved. It was a dead ball foul. Nebraska will maintain possession of the ball, first and 10.
Well, the Huskers keep it as Bo Pelini rolling the dice on fourth and 11 from the Nebraska 25-yard line, but obviously they loved what they saw from the Badgers' return punt return team as Sam Fultz just rolling off to his right. He had all kinds of space.
They almost had too many blockers out there. A.J. Jordan did a good job of getting inside the shield just to make the tackle.
Huskers have one timeout remaining. 1:57 left in the half. 24-17, Wisconsin. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Armstrong and the Huskers offense back out there. Jordan Westerkamp, one of the receivers, motions right to left. Armstrong back to throw, winds up, and he throws it deep down the middle for DeMornay Pearson. Hill pass overthrown. Incomplete, penalty marker flown. Penalty marker on the field. He had Shelton back there. Caputo on the coverage. As I think they may get Shelton for trying to tie up the receiver.
I'll tell you who feels really good about this. Zach Hannon. He was the lineman who was guilty of the dead ball foul before and set back Nebraska. Now they get those yards back on this penalty.
Ball at the 34 of Nebraska. 1:51 left in the half, 24-17, Wisconsin.
It's a good call. He was holding him.
Yep. Two receivers left, one on the right. Pearson L wide left, starts in motion. The snap to Armstrong. Back to throw. Pressured sack inside the 30-yard line of Nebraska. As the Badgers get to the quarterback. That was Peniel Jean crashing in on Armstrong. 1:35 clock running left till halftime. Another Novo Nordisk sack. Another $100 to the American Diabetes Association of Wisconsin. Ball at the Huskers 28-yard line, second and 16.
And Gene beat Abdullah, who's responsible for picking up the safety blitz.
1:20 clock running left in the half. Two receivers left, one to the right. Armstrong back to throw, winds up and again going deep to the right side for Kenny Bell. Lost his footing and the flag is thrown. Sojourn Shelton. It's going to be hit again. They were thinking about it, eyeballing it. I'm not sure if Bell tripped in his own, but the official says no, that Shelton tripped him up. And Nebraska is going to catch a break. Here's a call.
Defense number 8, 15 yards from the previous spot, automatic first down.
1:10 left in the half. And in college, it's a 15-yard penalty. And Nebraska inching up the field. Because of a couple of penalties here. Show the replay. You get the reaction. I'll tell you what, there wasn't much anything there.
Yeah, I didn't see anything.
Ball at the 42 of Nebraska, first and 10. Badgers lead by 7, 1:10 left in the half. Snap to Armstrong. Back to throw, winds up, shoots it to the right, and that's incomplete. Intended for Bell, Shelton in the coverage. At the 48 of the far side in Badger territory, second and 10 Nebraska with 1:04 left in the half.
Boy, Armstrong's all over with the ball, isn't he? He's either long or short with it.
He came in, the completion percentage 53%, 13 touchdowns. He's added one there today, 8 interceptions. Part of the book on him, though, is that he might give you a chance or two to pick one off during the course of the game. Westerkamp slot right, motions to the left. Snap to Armstrong, back to throw. Badgers bring in heat, and Armstrong down again. This time it's Goldberg with the sack at the 32-yard line of Nebraska. Clock running, 50 seconds left in the half. Another Novo Nordisk sack, another $100 to the American Diabetes Association of Wisconsin.
You really credit the pressure of Goldberg, Schobert, Gene. But the secondary coverage was awfully good, and that forced Armstrong to hold on to the football.
35 seconds, clock running left in the half. Third and 20 for the Huskers at their own 30-yard line. Two receivers left, one on the right. And Nebraska, I'm running here. Let's see what the Huskers do. Up, Armstrong wants to throw, sets up, and he's going to heave it deep to the right side. Incomplete, and that'll stop the clock with 16 seconds left in the first half. Remember, Wisconsin was out of timeouts, so they could have just run the ball and burned off the remaining time, but now they're going to have to line up and punt.
It was almost like they're just going to throw the ball deep and see if they can draw a flag.
Well, that was their best. Medicine in this drive. Yep. 30 yards of penalty, so I don't think that was a bad idea. Now, I don't think they'll fake punt this time.
Alonzo Moore, the intended receiver on that last play. Badgers in punt safe mode. The 32-yard line, and the whistles blow, and another penalty marker.
It's a procedure call on Huskers.
Kicking team number 10. 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
And they need to put time on the clock. There's that they Fultz punting. Snap clean, and the kick is away, and the Badgers were punt safe, so they're just letting this hit. Takes a bit of a Badger bounce, and it will roll to the 39 of Wisconsin, and with 6 seconds left in the half, the Badgers are back on offense and see if they just take a knee and get into the locker room, or we'll see if they take a shot. 24-17, Wisconsin. Toyota and your local Toyota dealers invite you to visit uwbadgers.com/Toyota to enter for a chance to win tickets and a special VIP experience at an upcoming Badger football game. Meet the coach, get on the field, and more. Enter today. Toyota, proud partner of Badger Athletics. The Badgers will, in fact, take a knee in a very entertaining first half has come to an end. If you're a Badger fan, it wasn't entertaining there for a while as Nebraska jumped to a 17-3 lead, but the Badgers put three touchdowns on the board. 62-yard run, Melvin Gordon, 17-yard run, Corey Clement, and a 5-yard pass from Joel Stavi to Sam Arneson, and we are halfway through here at Camp Randall Stadium. Your score, Wisconsin 24, Nebraska 17.
On the Badger Sports Network, this is the Wisconsin football dream season, presented by American Family Insurance. Also brought to you by your Wisconsin and UP Ford dealers, inviting you to visit your local Ford store or buyfordnow.com. UW Health Sports Medicine, treating the Badgers, treating you. Visit uwsportsmedicine.org. The Construction Business Group, Wisconsin operating engineers and respected contractors, building Wisconsin together. And by DeKalb, winning has roots. Perform at your best with DeKalb brand corn. This is Badger Halftime.
It's halftime of our dream season matchup as the Badgers have rallied from an early 14-point deficit to lead Nebraska 24-17. We love the classic games, but we know you want to know what's going on now as Paul Christen, this year's Badger football team, is going through the early days of spring practice, so we'll get you caught up on how things are going so far. You're enjoying the Wisconsin football dream season presented by American Family Insurance.
Preparation. It's the key to success on game day. And like your favorite Badgers on the field, you need to be ready right from the opening kickoff. Cenex has your pregame routine covered. We've got your salty snacks, your sweet treats, ice cold beverages to wash them down, and fresh tanks of propane to fire up the grill. Fuel your fandom at your local Cenex station. Badger pride, powered locally.
My favorite breakfast is Odyssey yogurt. I asked Mommy where it comes from, and she took me to a dairy farm to learn all about milk and, most importantly, cows. Wisconsin cows are definitely the happiest, which means they make the tastiest yogurt. My favorite is blueberry. What's your flavor? Support your local farmers. EIEI Odyssey.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet on the sunny side, the sunny side of the street.
I am so happy that football is back, this year especially, because it's been a while since we've all been together and just had that time to just work. And I think everybody had a great winter. We had a bunch of guys PRing in every lift, so it was definitely a very productive, and it was great for our team to have a winter. Coach Chris pulled out a stat in our team meeting the other day where it's like half of our team hasn't had a spring ball with COVID, so it was like 44 guys out of our entire team haven't had it. This spring ball means a ton to us, just growth and development, being able to learn, and guys that kind of just thrown into the season last year and didn't have that development period of spring ball. I mean, it's everything for young receivers, young playmakers, and guys on defense, just to get those reps. Those reps mean everything. For me, this is the fun part. It's where you get to challenge yourself and grow, and really just playing with great timing, anticipation, location, and it's been great working with Coach Chris up to this point. Selfishly, it's great for quarterbacks here, and if you're a high school quarterback, he is the guru when it comes to quarterbacking. These past 8 weeks of winter conditioning, I've felt that growth of not only being a quarterback on the field, but off the field, and that energy and that drive you need to bring every day. So he's truly taught me how to be a quarterback and live the life of a quarterback. I think for us, it's playing together and playing great complementary football and being able to feed off each other's energy. And obviously during spring, you're against defense every single time. But for us, it's how can we raise that level of competition and then just keep matching it every single day. It took me a while to learn, but it's being able to mess up and learn from it and not dwell on those mistakes and this is the time where you grow. That just goes back to our smart, tough, dependable, and what our program's about.
Come back out here and get something again on Thursday.
Let's go.
Let's get
UW
on 3, 1, 2,
3.
UW! Second half is coming up next as we enjoy the dream season presented by American Family Insurance.
Rock a drive block? Rush a pole crush? Jam a grand slam? Drunk? Drunk? That'd be insane! Roll in that? Roll in this? Roll together? Drunk?
That would be super insane!
Hey, all you ladies and guys. Drive sober on the road.
No matter how many wheels you roll.
If we build this, all the legendary players will magically appear, and we'll have sports again. I call it the Field of Fame. Of course, I'll have to tear down the garage, fill in the pool, and lose the trees. So can I get a loan?
So as your friend, I love it, but
as your banker, not so much.
Let me talk to the friend.
You could always invest in a college fund.
No, my kids aren't going to college. They're going to work at the stadium.
Our kids are going to college.
Sports are back.
My wife wants to build a college.
And not a moment too soon.
Buying your first home is the start of realizing bigger dreams with your family. That's why it's important to protect everything you love with American Family Insurance. Wait, what's that?
It's their dream car.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
It's actually my dream car. And my little dream tire swing with some dream trees. There'd be a nice dream garden right here too. Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly.
Nebraska receives here to begin the second half. Andrew Endicott with the kick in the air, and he hit this one a ton, and it's going to carry into the end zone for a touchback. And the Huskers will start at their 25-yard line. Second half underway with the Badgers leading 24-17.
Tosh, with an injury like an MCL to a running back like Abdullah, does the halftime hinder that injury at all? Does it make it more difficult to come out for the second half?
You definitely want to stay as warm as you possibly can because it's just a natural thing. He did this 2 weeks ago. There's going to be some stiffness and some soreness, so you'd like to just keep it going. So with this weather and with that break, it's not going to help him any.
Two receivers right, one on the left. Abdullah, the running back, behind the quarterback, Tommy Armstrong. First snap here in the second half of play, and penalty markers fly. A little movement up front again as Nebraska hit with a false start penalty right out of the gate.
The Badgers are stemming right before the ball is snapped. And when they move, when those two down linemen are moving, it's drawing motion from that O-line for Nebraska.
Well, with this look away or whatever you guys want to call it, you're looking at the side, you're not getting into a rhythm, and linemen do not like to be in a stance all day. They like to move.
That's the fifth penalty for 35 yards against Nebraska so far in this game. The Badgers have been hit three times for 30. First and 15, Huskers at their own 20, and the handoff to Abdullah. He goes nowhere. Cut down by Joe Schobert right at the line of scrimmage, which is the Nebraska 20, second and 15.
Can't play that any better. They pulled their left guard, Jay Cotton's most experienced player on that old line, and Schobert played through the guard and made the tackle.
These penalties, these five-yard penalties, this Nebraska's the same as Wisconsin. Needs to stay normal down a distance. Really puts Nebraska at a big disadvantage.
Badgers in their nickel on second down and 15 for the Huskers from their own 20-yard line. Two receivers left, one on the right. Danielle Jean creeping up to the line of scrimmage. Play clock is at five. Armstrong calling for the ball. Caputo storming up to the line of scrimmage. And here's Armstrong running right. And he is run down from behind by Michael Caputo at the 22-yard line of Nebraska. Gain of two. And the Huskers have a third and 13.
You got to like the cat and mouse that time with Dave Arandi. He brings up Danielle Jean to the line of scrimmage. Backs him out. Brings Caputo from the other side.
Michael with that running start. Able to, from the back side, catch the quarterback. Third down and 13 for the Huskers at their own 22-yard line. Just underway third quarter. 24-17 Wisconsin leading Nebraska. Two receivers left, one on the right. Armstrong sends Terrell Newby from the backfield, motioning to the left. Armstrong to throw over the middle, caught by Abdullah. Now slanting right, 20, 25, 30, 35 to the 40. Cutting inside to his left is Abdullah across the 25. And brought down near midfield, the 45 up to the 48-yard line. As Nebraska on third and long gets a big play. And a first down for the Huskers.
Give credit to the offensive coordinator, Tim Beck. He caught Wisconsin without a down lineman. They were in an amoeba defense, and he hit the screen on him.
Eric Landish finally able to run down Amir Abdullah. And for the 48 of the Huskers, it is first and 10. 2 minutes gone by here in the third quarter. Badgers up by seven. Armstrong back to throw, pressured by Beagle. Armstrong rolls right, winds up, and throws it deep. And this is a room service interception. Peniel Jean inside the five. He's slanting right across the 10. Jean slips, falls down across the 15-yard line as Armstrong just threw that one up. That was like a punt. And Peniel Jean with the interception as the Badgers get their second takeaway of the day.
He didn't know Jean, the safety, was over the top. He had Shelton and Bell tied up, and he was just trying to throw the ball away. I'm assuming. What do you think, Tausch?
Well, Sojourn Shelton, I like, puts his arms up to make sure, hey, I'm not in this for an interference. This ball was so poorly thrown, and I'm not sure if he was trying to throw it away. If he did, it was not very well executed.
Well, the Badgers get their first interception of the day against Armstrong. They recovered a fumble. Did the Badgers in the second quarter and capitalize. They'll start at their 17, first and 10. Joel Stabby, the quarterback, and they give to Melvin Gordon across the 20. Gordon, 25-yard line, and wrestled down there. Make Gary the safety on the tackle, and another good strong run from Melvin Gordon. Badger O-line carving out space, and Gordon goes for about 9 to the 26.
Gary Anderson was telling us this week that Nate Gary, number 25, is a lot like Michael Caputo. Plays with that same type of intensity. He's also a ball hawk. He has four picks in the secondary for the Huskers.
Yep, one in each of the last three games. Gary, a sophomore out of Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Double wide to the left of the Badgers, 26. Second down and one. And Stabby will give it to Gordon again. Penalty marker is thrown, and Gordon works his way near the 30-yard line. Trevor Roach, a linebacker on the stop.
Penalty it's either a hold or a chop block.
Now it's going to be a hold on Costigan, I think.
Here's the call.
Offense number 54, 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat second down.
That is Kyle Costigan.
What I saw there is it was just a down block. A simple counter play, pull the left guard at a down block. And what Costigan did is he finished him to the ground. And anytime that happens, the ref sees that. I don't even think it was a hold, but it looked like a hold. And that's why they threw the flag.
3 minutes gone by in the third quarter, 24-17 Wisconsin. The Badgers have a second and 11 from their own 16-yard line. Watt and Gordon, backfield combo. Stavi under center, takes hands off Gordon over the right side of the line, gets to the 20-yard line, stood up, driven back. Zaire Anderson getting in there, but it was first on the scene for Nebraska was Trevor Roach. And the Badgers have a third down and seven at their own 20-yard line.
Now this is where you have to be aware again of number four, Randy Gregory. We haven't made the call on him very often after Gordon got involved, engaged in the game with his running ability. But when you're in a passing situation, Gregory is a terror.
Yeah, he made some noise very early in this game, did Gregory. But you're right, been pretty quiet for an extended period. Double wide to the left. They got three on the left, and now one of those receivers, Jordan Frederick, in motion to the right. Stabby back to throw. Steps up, pressured, and sacked. Well, I don't think Gregory's, he's not going to get the sack credit for it, but he helped force the issue, helped get Joel to step into the pocket, and then help from his teammates, specifically defensive tackle Malik Collins, and the ball is marked at the Badger 15.
Just too much pressure up the middle there. Malik Collins got a little bit of an edge on Costigan because the tackles actually did a nice job getting the pocket. You know, they got it up vertically, but there was just nowhere for Stave to step up.
Drew Meyer on the punt. Line of scrimmage, the 15 of Wisconsin, and the snap clean, pressure light, and the kick is in the air, returnable for Pearsonell across midfield, breaking to his right to the 45, now reverses field, circles to his left to the 45 of Wisconsin, to the 40 of the Badgers, and he will be out of bounds inside the 40-yard line. And Bo Pelini campaigning for a late hit there, but no penalty marker is thrown. As getting there was Troy Fumagalli.
One thing about Pelini, he hasn't mellowed, has he, in the time that he's been in this league? You could say that with some conviction.
Well, Nebraska with very good field position. It had great field position throughout the first quarter. 10:07 left in the third period. 24-17 Wisconsin, but the Huskers have a first and 10 at the Badger 38-yard line. No, I'd say Bo Pelini still has a fair amount of energy. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. Abdullah the running back. Abdullah 13 carries, 61 yards so far. Pistol formation and a handoff to Abdullah, and the ball's knocked loose, and a big pile at the 42-yard line, and the Badgers have it. Amir Abdullah cough set up. Vince Beagle forcing it, and Peniel Jean pounces.
Well, that's the type of play we've seen Wisconsin have opportunities to make in the past. In fact, last week at Purdue, the ball was on the turf. They couldn't get to it. Beagle made the tremendous play, stripping it from Abdullah, and then Peniel Jean responding like a Chris Borland to the loose ball on the turf and claiming it.
I was trying to see if anyone actually blocked Beagle or if he made his guy miss, but he came in flying in there with no one touching him, did a nice job of not only getting the tackle secured, but stripping it out like a chainsaw. That was outstanding, and then great awareness to recover that fumble.
Second Nebraska turnover of the third quarter, and we're only 5 minutes into it, 24-17 Wisconsin. Badgers starting at their 42-yard line, first and 10. And a little boot to the left. Here comes Stabby. He'll shoot it left side. Erickson, the sliding catch in Nebraska territory at the 45-yard line of the Huskers. Gain of 13, Stabby to Alex Erickson. First down, Wisconsin, and now Stabby comes out. McAvoy in at quarterback.
Well, that's a nice route run by Erickson. The timing between Erickson and Stabby, just perfect. There was nothing that defensive back Mitchell could do.
That is not easy. Stave rolls left. What he did, why he threw that accurately, got his shoulders square to the line of scrimmage.
Melvin Gordon comes out wide to the right. First down, McAvoy reads and keeps working the right side, faking the handoff to Corey Clement. He's back into the lineup. Inside the 40 goes McAvoy to the 39 of Nebraska, gain of 6. And now McAvoy will come out, Stavi back in on 2nd and 4, Wisconsin at the Huskers 39-yard line.
It almost appeared the Badgers were going to go with tempo there. Corey Clement was trying to call everyone up to the line of scrimmage, but they changed their mind.
9-10 and counting left in the third quarter, 24-17 Wisconsin. And again, Gordon comes out wide to the right, Kenzel Doe tight to the left. Corey Clement the running back, Stavi under center. And Melvin Gordon started in motion, flinched, then stopped, and got caught. Penalty marker flies. This will cost the Badgers 5 yards.
We've had a couple of mistakes here on their first two possessions of the third quarter. Flags can stop drives.
Especially with how Wisconsin's offense is playing. You're staying in normal down, and, you know, the holding penalty against Costigan stopped that one. Now at least you picked up a great gain on first down. This is something that you can overcome, but you know the penalties will catch up.
For the 44 of Nebraska, it is 2nd down and 9 for Wisconsin. Gordon slot right, and now the give to Gordon, sweeping left outside the numbers. 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 10, 5, and he is down at the 1. Melvin Gordon. Down to the 1 yard line of Nebraska, first and goal. Wisconsin, Nate Gary saving the touchdown for the moment, assuming they don't review it.
With Sam Arneson well out on the perimeter, tying up the linebacker. I believe it was Zaire Anderson.
What was great about Arneson there, he is out in space. All the refs are looking at him, hands inside tight. And then when Gordon went by him, let his arms go to make sure to see no holding penalty.
Badgers back into the Case IH red zone. First and goal, Wisconsin at the Nebraska 1 yard line. Gordon the tailback, Watt the fullback. Hand off Melvin over the right side. Touchdown, Melvin Gordon. His second touchdown of the day, and he now has 295 rushing yards. 30-17, Wisconsin.
How many power plays do you think Wisconsin has run since Barry Alvarez got here, if we go all the way back to 90, one of the patented plays of a Wisconsin offense, especially in O-line, Tausch.
Nice job there by Traylor. We say a lot about his blocking. He finished his man into the end zone, allowing Gordon to follow right behind.
Rafael Gaglianone on to attempt the extra point as the Badgers with a 2-score lead. Extra point is good, and we have a break. in the action.
May 3rd through the 7th is Teacher Appreciation Week, but why wait to thank an educator for keeping learning on track during this extraordinary school year? Post a thank you note to a Wisconsin public school teacher at WEAC.org. We act, we teach, we inspire. And WEA member benefits, enhancing the financial lives of Wisconsin public school employees.
Cancer is often detected too late. At Exact Sciences, we're working to change lives by helping to detect cancer earlier. Headquartered in Madison, Exact Sciences is growing and needs dedicated, energetic individuals to join our team. You don't have to be a scientist to work at Exact Sciences. We're hiring for our laboratory and customer care teams and have hundreds of job openings for people of all backgrounds and experience levels. Visit ExactSciences.com to learn more and join the fight against cancer. Change careers, change lives. Exact Sciences.
Hard work, sweat, knowledge, and your own two hands. These are the tools that build Wisconsin. Leave your mark on the real world with zero debt and higher pay. All from day one. It's time to do work that works for you. Learn more at buildingwisconsintogether.com.
Stick with this, or do you? I think you have to continue what's been working for you because the passing game is going to be a struggle.
Pass look right now, although Abdullah, who was wide left, motions into the backfield. They're going to hand it to Amir Abdullah running right across the 25-yard line, and Abdullah lost the ball, and Chikwe Obashi is all over it. Badger football inside the Nebraska 30.
I want to say Landish was on the tackle. I don't know if he made the forced fumble or not, Matt.
Not sure. Want to look at it again.
There was a pileup. It was almost a scrum, and the ball just popped free. Was he down or not? That's what Abdullah seems to be asking.
Yeah, Abdullah saying, wait a minute, I thought I was down. The ball's at the Nebraska 27-yard line. First and 10, Wisconsin, at least right now. And no review indication yet. And now there is.
The ruling on the field is the ball was fumbled, recovered by Wisconsin. That ruling is under further review.
You're right, Mike. It was Landish on the tackle. And the question is, was Amir Abdullah still up before the ball came out? And again, I don't think there's going to be enough there to overturn it, at least on the looks we've seen so far. Ruling on the field was it was a fumble, and if so, then both of these terrific running backs will have coughed it up twice in this game, if it stands.
It was first contact Landish, second Marcus Trotter.
Tom Fielder, the replay official. And this one is going to be a little bit more difficult. We're taking a look at an angle right now where Trotter's right knee is obstructing the view of the football a little bit, but it looks as though there might be a chance that they could rule Abdullah had a knee on the turf. But again, I'm not sure there's enough to overturn the call on the field. 7:58 left in the third quarter. It's 31-17, Wisconsin leading Nebraska.
The runner's knee was down before the ball came out. As a result, it'll be second and one. The 34-yard line.
So there you go. And that last angle seemed to be the one that was most favorable to Nebraska. So with the snow flying here, a little light snowfall, we are about set to resume play with Wisconsin leading by 14. Nebraska led by 14 early in the second quarter, 17-3, but since then, the Badgers have taken control. It is have to remark the ball here because the ball had popped out after the play and went to the Nebraska 27, but they remarked the play blown dead at the 34 of Nebraska. It's now second and one for the Huskers. Double wide to the left. Janovich, the fullback, to the right of Armstrong. Abdullah back there as well. And he takes the handoff. Abdullah running right, caught behind the line of scrimmage. And that was Vince Beagle getting to the star back for Nebraska. Loss of two to the 32 of the Huskers.
Boy, did he mishandle the tight end.
Wow.
Backed him back on his heels, didn't he?
That was just, I am stronger than you. I'm going to shove my way back there and make the tackle. That was big boy football.
That was Sam Cotton, who got beaten by Beagle.
Third down and three for the Huskers at their 32-yard line. Two receivers left, one on the right. Play clock at 10 as Armstrong gets the offense organized. Pistol formation, Abdullah behind the quarterback, takes the snap, option left. Armstrong drilled behind the line of scrimmage. Oh my goodness, Joe Schobert taking care of business on third down as Armstrong is thrown down at the 29 of Nebraska.
Caputo came on a blitz, guessed right, was coming down, forcing Armstrong to take that back inside right into the arms of Schobert.
6:40 and counting left in the third quarter. Sam Foltz on the punt. Kenzel Doe, single safety at the Badger 38. Snap clean, pressure light, kick is away. Doe angles to his left on the back pedal. Fair catch called and made near the 25-yard line in Badger territory.
Johnsonville Sausage has been family-owned and making Badger Saturdays more delicious since 1945. Pick some up for a cookout, made the Johnsonville way.
University of Wisconsin Carbone Cancer Center, providing cancer research, education, and treatment for people throughout Wisconsin and Northern Illinois. Information at uwhealth.org/cancer. UW Health, providing specialty and primary care for all ages throughout Wisconsin. Information on UW Health physicians and clinics and on University of Wisconsin Hospital, available on the web at uwhealth.org.
We believe in education. We believe in public schools. At WEA Member Benefits, we believe in helping Wisconsin public school employees and their families achieve their financial goals by providing personal insurance, retirement and investment, and financial planning programs that are designed specifically for the education community. WEABenefits.com.
It takes attention to detail. With your local Bryant dealer, you're getting more than just a technician. You're getting someone who pays attention to your needs and the little things that make a big difference. It takes a dealer you can rely on. And to keep your family cool this summer,
let me show you how this works.
It takes Bryant.
Bryant. Whatever it takes.
Record for a single game is 339. Ron Dayne set it in 96 at Hawaii. Backs off set. Kenzel Doe wide left, motions to the right. Give Gordon running right. There he goes. 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Down the sideline. Gordon to the 30, to the 20, to the 10. And he is down inside the 5-yard line. Melvin Gordon pops another long one. And he has himself a single game school rushing record at the University of Wisconsin. That runs 69 yards for Melvin Gordon. They will mark it at the 6. They mark it at the 6-yard line of Nebraska. First down, goal to go, Wisconsin.
Only the hustle of the safety, Nate Gary, prevented a touchdown because he had blockers downfield in Kenzel Doe and Alex Erickson.
Melvin Gordon with 363 yards and counting. First and goal at the Nebraska 6. Hand off Melvin, running left, make it 369, make it touchdown, Wisconsin. Melvin Gordon putting on a show for the ages for Wisconsin football.
Nebraska had a bust defensively again. Josh Mitchell is the corner to that side of the run,
didn't know what the play was. You could tell before the snap, went inside with the receiver. There was absolutely no one for contain on the outside. No one set the edge.
37-17, Wisconsin. Gaglianone, the extra point. It is good. And we have a break in the action. 5:46 left in the third quarter. Wisconsin 38, Nebraska 17. This is Badger football from Learfield Sports.
Have kids 6th grade and under at home? Join Bucky's Kids Club, presented by Culver's. Register for free at uwbadgers.com/kidsclub.
You've heard the saying, if it looks like bacon and it tastes like sausage, it's probably Johnsonville sausage strips. Oh, you never heard that? Well, sausage strips are pretty new. They're strips of sausage in amazing flavors like maple and chorizo. You can find this meaty miracle by the bacon, even though it's sausage.
Whoa.
In these challenging, uncertain, uncharted times, you stand strong. No matter the conditions you face, you get the job done. You are the backbone of our communities.
As we prepare to move forward, stay healthy. Appreciate life. Be safe. Treasure moments. Plan well.
With the kickoff for Wisconsin. And Kenny Bell 5 yards deep, and he's coming out goal line to the 5. Bell the 10, cutting right 15, spinning across the 20. Bell up to the 24-yard line, so he's just trying to make something happen. And yeah, the little gamble, if you want to call it that, ends up costing him a yard. Could have taken the touchback. He runs it out to the 24 of the Huskers, first and 10, Nebraska.
Now, we've seen the resiliency out of this Nebraska team once already this year at Michigan State on the road. They rallied for 17 points in the fourth quarter. So it is, despite the score right now, you have to keep that in mind that this team has done it before.
Yeah, it was 27-3. Michigan State led the fourth quarter. Fans were leaving. It was a little chilly. It was raining. And the next thing you know, it was 27-22, and Nebraska had the ball. Movement again up front, and another false start coming up against Nebraska. That'll back him up, and it's first and 15. Tausch talking about it throughout the course of this game, trying to stay normal offensively, and Nebraska's just not doing it.
Yeah, and the linemen are in their stance for a while. They're excited to get that ball snapped, and just the late shift there by Warren Herring, shifted over, allowed their left tackle just to flinch to set him in a first and 15.
Now it's at the 19-yard line of Nebraska. Four receivers, two either way. Armstrong, little quarterback draw. He's to the 20. Armstrong to the 24. That's the original line of scrimmage. And it's second down and 10 for the Huskers. 5:25 and counting. Left third quarter, 38-17. Wisconsin leads Nebraska. Four receivers, two either way. Snapped Armstrong. Rolling left, chased by Beagle, throwing left. And that's caught by Brandon Wiley, who will step out of bounds across the 35 to the 38 of the far side. And there's the first catch of the season for Brandon Wiley, sophomore from Lincoln, Nebraska. First down Huskers at the 38-yard line. 5:10, clock running left third quarter. Badgers lead 38-17. Three receivers on the right, one on the left. Armstrong, option left, fakes the toss. He'll keep it and get tagged at the line of scrimmage by Joe Schobert. He's a sound-looking player, isn't he, Joe Schobert?
Oh, he's had a big game today.
That's just what happens when a defense does what it's supposed to do. Beagle has contain, keeps the contain. Schobert chases down with good pursuit. Gets him down to the ground.
Schobert, 10 tackles, 3.5 TFLs.
Second down, snap to Armstrong, rolling right, guns it right side, and Brandon Riley trying to make the rolling catch, could not at the 43 of the near side. It would have been a five-yard gain had he been able to gather, but Riley unable to do so, and it's now third and 10 for the Huskers at their 38-yard line.
The one thing this Nebraska offense doesn't have from previous offenses that we've seen is a tight end that can scare a defense.
Yeah, you're right. They just don't really seem to have that. Amani Cross now in the backfield for Nebraska. Three receivers to the right. Play clock is at 8. Third and 10 Huskers at their own 38. Armstrong to throw. Badgers bringing heat. Armstrong throwing right side. Wants Westerkamp, and it's incomplete at the 30-yard line of the near side. Good coverage from Darius Hillary, and Nebraska forced to punt on 4th and 10.
Nebraska actually did a nice job of picking up the blitz there. Wisconsin brought a little bit of pressure, and he threw it. Just try to put a play out there that they can make a play on, and a nice job there by Hillary to break it up.
Sam Foltz will punt. Kenzel Doe deep at the Badgers' 26-yard line. Snap to Foltz, pressure light, and the kick is away. And again, Foltz hangs this in the air. Another fair catch signaled by Kenzel Doe, and he rolls to the turf at the 27-yard line. A penalty marker flies because Kenzel signaled for the fair catch, made it, rolled to the turf, and then got hit. Not much, but enough. In fact, more of a love tap.
It was Kevin
snapper.
Williams. It just sort of fell into him, which was not a very smart play.
No, not a ton of contact there, but the fact that there was drew the penalty markers.
That was Falkenberg. Check that. Josh Falkenberg. He's the snapper. No wonder.
Long snapper, yep. 4:09 left of the third quarter. 38-17, Wisconsin. Badger offense back at it, and they have great field position at their own 42-yard line. Melvin Gordon with a school record for a single game, 369 rushing yards on 22 carries. And he's right back in there for the Badgers. Joel Stavi, the quarterback. Receivers either side of the formation. Rushing wide right, motions left. They'll fake the fly sweep, hand off Gordon straight ahead, and he almost popped through across the 45, tripped up and taken down at the 49-yard line as he just about slipped through the traffic up the middle. He gets 7.
That had to be a good sight for Utah's hat on hat, helmet on helmet. And they almost created the crease.
I was going to say, offensive linemen always just want to get their running back to a safety. And when they've done that today, we've seen the results with all these explosive runs.
Gordon with 376 rushing yards, one shy of the Big Ten single-game record. Gordon wide right, motions left, the fake to sweep to Gordon to left. Here's the give to Doe, sweeping right, 50, 45, Doe to the 40, 35, 30, 25 to the 20-yard line. And finally pushed out of bounds. They'll mark at the 20 of Nebraska.
Nice play design. Gave it fake to Corey Clement. Then obviously everybody is watching Melvin Gordon. A fake pitch the other way to the right. And then Clement is actually a lead blocker for Kenzel Doe. Really nice play call. Nice design. Nice execution.
3:15 left third quarter. 38-17. The Badgers. Now a first and 10 at the Huskers' 20-yard line. Corey Clement in at running back. Melvin Gordon wide to the right. Erickson to the left. Gordon in motion. And they'll fake the jet sweep. McAvoy keeps running right to the 20. McAvoy to the 15-yard line and cut down at the 12, maybe the 11. Oh, Andy Ludwig, the offensive coordinator, showing some interesting looks here these last couple of plays. McAvoy for 8, second down and 2 at the Huskers' 12. The Badgers back into the Case IH red zone.
Just using Gordon as a big-time decoy right now. And Arneson again, out in space with his blocking today. Hands inside. Another nice job allowing McAvoy to pick up 8.
Gordon, the tailback. Watt, the fullback. Melvin with 376 rushing yards. The Big Ten record is 377, currently held by Anthony Thompson. It's about to be broken. Here's Gordon running right inside the 10, and Gordon bounces to the turf at the 7-yard line. And the former Hoosier star, Anthony Thompson, now will step aside as Melvin Gordon with a Big Ten single game rushing record. They'll mark the ball at the 7-yard line of Nebraska. And it's first and goal, Wisconsin. The NCAA single game record is 406, set by LaDainian Tomlinson back in 1999. Gordon now has 382. Gordon, the running back. Single back offense, Erickson single wide to the left. Here's the give to Gordon, to the 5. Gordon to the end zone, touchdown Wisconsin. Penalty marker on the play, hang on. And here comes the call.
Offense number 54, 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Costigan called for the hold. 1:45 left in the third quarter. 38-17, Wisconsin.
You almost get the feeling that that's just going to, it's not even that big a deal. The way Gordon is running, it's just going to help him break that record that we've been talking about.
Anytime you throw a defender to the turf, they're going to call you for holding. It doesn't make any sense to me. Watch it. Look at it, Tausch. Tell me.
Well, it's what we said. It's you want to finish, you want to do that. But when you do that, the refs see it, and then they get in their mind, maybe we should throw a flag on it.
Officially, we'll call the line of scrimmage the 16 of Nebraska. First down, McAvoy fakes the handoff to Clement. Tanner slanting to his left, gets inside the 15, down to about the 11 of the Cornhuskers. It's a gain of 5 for McAvoy, and from there it's second and goal at the Nebraska 11. 90 seconds left in the third quarter, 38-17, Wisconsin.
He needed to stick with the instinct, stay inside. If he stays inside the block, he would have had a big gain. He tried to go outside, got tackled.
Melvin Gordon comes out wide to the left. He has 382 rushing yards in this game. Double wide to the right. Gordon in motion left to right. McAvoy fakes the jet sweep. He'll run it. He's gone. Slanting left to the 5. McAvoy to the end zone. Touchdown, Wisconsin. 382 rushing yards, and Melvin Gordon's the best decoy in the world.
They simply have no answers defensively for what Wisconsin's doing. None.
That drive, Melvin Gordon didn't have a ton of yards, but every other yard that was picked up was because of him. Great play designs, everybody knowing Nebraska's going to flow, and it just comes back the other way.
44-17, Wisconsin.
No one can thrive on an empty stomach, and that's why Alliant Energy continues to help fight hunger in Wisconsin. Alliant Energy, using our energy for good in the communities we serve.
Hey Badger fans, Matza Matt for Brewpub Lots of Matza Pizzas. Absolutely loving these Dream Season Badger games from back in the day. Hey, speaking of back in the day, remember when frozen pizzas were like a piece of cardboard laden with a flavorless sauce, topped with ingredients you'd reach after 5 bites, then sparsely decorated with cheese? Well, not anymore. Brewpub Lots of Matza Pizzas came along and were a game changer. A crispy, thin cracker crust topped with a bold sauce, loaded with quality meat and veggie toppings, then bombarded with over 1/2 pound of award-winning mozzarella cheese. Brewpub Pizzas, the perfect pizza, no matter the season.
As a Wisconsin Badgers football fan, you probably know a thing or two about consistent, top-quality performance. Hi, I'm Gary Leeper, General Manager at Dairyland Seed. And for over 110 years, we've been delivering nothing but the industry's best seed designed to deliver higher yields and unmatched quality to farmers in all environments and conditions. So just as you can bet on Bucky dominating the ground game, you can count on Dairyland Seed to be your most valuable partner each and every season. Dairyland Seed, proud sponsor of Wisconsin football and Wisconsin farmers.
University of Wisconsin-Carbone Cancer Center, providing cancer research, education, and treatment for people throughout Wisconsin and northern Illinois. Information at uwhealth.org/cancer. UW Health, providing specialty and primary care for all ages throughout Wisconsin. Information on UW Health physicians and clinics and on University of Wisconsin Hospital, available on the web at uwhealth.org.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Abdullah to the left of Armstrong. And a play fake. Armstrong throwing, ball's tipped in the air, tipped again, and pulled down by Jordan Westerkamp at the 30-yard line. That's the first catch of the day for Jordan Westerkamp as he did a dangerous thing. It went off Westerkamp's hand. He was able to pull it down after a Badger was able to get
Warren
a piece
Herring.
Of it.
Warren Herring deflected the pass.
They'll mark at the 29 of Nebraska's second down and six. And 20 seconds left in the third quarter in snowy Madison, Wisconsin. And Armstrong, bad exchange, and the Badgers pounce on the loose ball. Another Nebraska turnover. Marcus Trotter falling on the loose ball. A poor exchange between Armstrong and Abdullah. And the Badgers going back to work with 12 seconds left in quarter number three.
There was some penetration. Abdullah had his eyes on those red jerseys in front of him. Looked like the ball might have been on his hip. Never made the exchange, Armstrong.
Definitely not a clean exchange. I think Abdullah was actually looking up at some of that penetration, and that is where he didn't quite secure it, and the ball just sat there for Wisconsin to pounce on.
It was Obashi that was in his face.
Ball's at the Nebraska 26. First down, Wisconsin. Melvin Gordon with 382 rushing yards. The NCAA single game record is 406. Stavi back to throw, looking, sets, shoots it to the right, and it's broken up incomplete at the 15-yard line of the far side. Zaire Anderson, the outside linebacker, breaking up the pass intended for Sam Arneson. 6 seconds left in the third quarter, and it's second and 10, Wisconsin at the Nebraska 26.
We were worried a lot about Nebraska's front rushing the passer. Again, throwing it on first down, that was nice protection. You're throwing in a down, you're expecting to run. Nice clean pocket for Stave to throw in.
Alex Erickson wide to the right, Kenzel Doe to the left. Backfield combo, Derek Watt, Melvin Gordon. Straight eye formation. On second and 10 from the Nebraska 26-yard line. Here comes Melvin to the 25, to the 20. Gordon 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Wisconsin. Record-breaking run, Melvin Gordon, 4-0-8.
Well, he put an exclamation mark at the end of that dash by stepping through a tackle attempt by Corey Cooper before stepping into the end zone.
Just a man amongst boys. It is, it's every time he breaks through, you're expecting him now to finish these runs. He, unbelievable performance. I think one of the best performances we've ever seen.
Injured Nebraska player on the touchdown run.
It's Gregory, I believe, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Junior defensive lineman. As the athletic trainer is taking a look at Gregory. Melvin Gordon, 408 rushing yards. And he passes LaDainian Tomlinson for the single game NCAA rushing mark.
And it's early.
Yeah, there's a quarter left.
I think he might be done. You think?
That play there, I know. Nice job by Havenstein. We can give Gordon all the applause we want. He deserves it. Havenstein washed his guy down and again got him to a safety where Gordon made him miss again and finished another long run.
Gregory being helped off, favoring, I believe, the left leg, not putting much weight at all.
Gregory was injured earlier in the season, missed almost three full games for the Huskers. And after flashing early in the first quarter, we have not heard a thing from Gregory.
No, we have not. Gaglianone to attempt the extra point. As, by the way, we have hit the end of the third quarter. Extra point, the kick in the air, and it is good.
It's that time, Badger fans. It's time for the great student section race presented by UW Continuing Studies.
you better back up. Try and play the role and you're the whole club will act up. Get up, stand up, come on, put your hands up if you got the feeling. Jump up, touch the ceiling, monks, let's a bump up. Someone's fucking jump, yeah, I'll bust them in the eye. And then I'll take the punks, feeling funky. Amps in the junk and I got more rhymes than this cops at a Dunkin' Donuts shop. Sure enough, I got rocks from the kids on the hill. With my mom and my pops, I can't make it down, I can't make it down. So get out your seat and jump around, jump around.
Endicott's kick in the air will sail into the end zone. It'll be a touchback. Melvin Gordon is averaging 16.3 yards per carry. Huskers will start at their 25-yard line, first and 10.
Well, the key thing is the work is not yet done for this Wisconsin football team. Not necessarily here today. But in order to get to Indianapolis, there is a lot of work left starting next week at Iowa.
Yeah, that's why I was suggesting that the work may be done.
No, that
for
was prudent.
For Melvin.
Yeah, prudent, yeah, on your part.
Iowa, by the way, won at Illinois today, 30-14. That's the next game on the schedule for Wisconsin. On first down, handoff Abdullah across the 25, and Amir Abdullah up to about the 29-yard line on a gain of 4. Beagle in there, Marcus Trotter as well.
Linebackers have played just an outstanding game. Schobert, Trotter, all these guys have done, really have stepped up. I don't know how many tackles they're going to end up with, but they're going to be leading the stat sheet at the end of this game.
Second down and 6. Sam Cotton, the tight end, motions left to right. And the give to Abdullah again, not much, to about the 30-yard line. Landish getting in there for Wisconsin.
I mean, there's so very little you can do if you're back the offensive coordinator when your quarterback is 4 of 16 for 58 yards.
Yeah, you're right. A real struggle, and he's also thrown an interception. That occurred early in the third quarter. Third down and 5. Armstrong throwing to the left, caught by Kenny Bell, and he's going to be nabbed. And the ball popped out, and it goes out of bounds. At the 28-yard line in Nebraska territory, where they may have given the progress, they may have ruled the play down. They did. It's still short of the first down, as they're going to mark it at the 32. So the Huskers have a 4th and 3 at their own 32-yard line.
Great effort there, Schobert running in again. We've said that name a lot this afternoon, and a nice job there and coming in and getting him down on the ground for another tackle.
Sam Foltz on the punt for Nebraska. And he hit this one well. Alex Erickson signals for the fair catch. And he'll make it at the 17-yard line, maybe the 18 in Wisconsin territory. And we have a break in the action.
Enjoy this dream season with the meal of your dreams. Head to Culver's where you can enjoy the original Culver's Butter Burger. Fresh beef cooked to order and topped with a lightly buttered toasted bun. Welcome to Delicious.
We believe in education. We believe in public schools. At WEA Member Benefits, we believe in helping Wisconsin public school employees and their families achieve their financial goals by providing personal insurance, retirement and investment, and financial planning programs that are designed specifically for the education community. WEABenefits.com.
You've heard the saying, if it looks like bacon and it tastes like sausage, it's probably Johnsonville sausage strips. Oh, you never heard that? Well, sausage strips are pretty new. They're strips of sausage in amazing flavors like maple and chorizo. You can find this meaty miracle by the bacon, even though it's sausage.
Whoa.
Because of this, we made Ford Super Duty the most capable heavy-duty pickup ever. Because of this, we built Ford F-150 with 375 horsepower and best-in-class payload.
Rescue 614 in route.
Because of this, we built Ford Ranger with the Terrain Management System. And because Ford trucks are built for this, you made Ford America's best-selling brand.
Badgers starting at their 18-yard line, first and 10. Rob Wheelwright, wide right, motions left, handoff Clement. Going north-south, and he'll be stopped shy of the 20-yard line. That's Jonathan Rose out of the secondary, a junior. That leads Arkansas on the tackle. We'll mark at the 20 of Wisconsin, second down and 8 coming up for the Badgers.
Good to see that Clement is able to get back in this game because he is, you know, Gordon is obviously a stud, but Clement, you need his physical running. You need him to be available as well.
The Badgers just trying to burn time off the clock. 12:40 to play, 52-17, the Badgers. Stavi will give it to Clement again across the 20-yard line, lowers the shoulders and bangs his way to about the 23. And that'll bring up third down and 5.
Tosh, to follow up on what you're saying about Clement, not only can he stand alone as a tailback, but the Badgers like utilizing both Clement and Gordon in the same backfield because it gives them a kind of a different look and puts even more pressure on the defense.
Yeah, you just, when he got up from that great touchdown run, you were concerned the way he was going. It's great to see him back out here and able to finish this game.
Third down and 5 for the Badgers at their 23-yard line. Wheelwright goes out to the right. Erickson to the left. Wheelwright motions right to left. Teasing fly sweep and trying to bounce to the left is Corey Clement, and he brought down at the line of scrimmage. And that was Vincent Valentine, who's had stops in each of the last two plays, 325-pound sophomore defensive tackle. Harry Anderson talking before the game about how impressed he has been watching the video of guys like Valentine and Malik Collins, a couple of 300-pound D tackles. This Badger offense has just gone to work today. And Melvin Gordon with a record-setting day, 408 rushing yards this afternoon. Last two games against Nebraska, he's rushed for 624 yards and 5 touchdowns, all 34 carries. Going back to that Big Ten title game 2 years ago. Drew Meyer with the punt. This one pops up and will roll to a stop near midfield, about the 47-yard line in Wisconsin territory, and we have a timeout on the field.
Dairyland Seed offers Wisconsin farmers elite genetics in corn, soybeans, alfalfa, and silage. Visit dairylandseed.com to learn more.
As we prepare to move forward, stay healthy, appreciate life, be safe, treasure moments, plan well.
Cancer is often detected too late. At Exact Sciences, we're working to change lives by helping to detect cancer earlier. Headquartered in Madison, Exact Sciences is growing and needs dedicated, energetic individuals to join our team. You don't have to be a scientist to work at Exact Sciences. We're hiring for our laboratory and customer care teams and have hundreds of job openings for people of all backgrounds and experience levels. Visit ExactSciences.com to learn more and join the fight against cancer. Change careers, change lives. Exact Sciences.
Little deflating moment at the moment for Wisconsin, but obviously things got a lot better the rest of the way as they try a little pitch end around to DeMornay Pearson-L, and he gets just a couple of yards running left and trying to cut it back inside. Marcus Trotter on the stop, gain of 2 to the Badger 45-yard line.
That's getting to be a little bit more popular in college football. Instead of the handoff on that fly sweep, just in case the ball ends up on the ground, it's not a fumble just by pitching it.
A completed pass for Tommy Armstrong, and that gets him now to 6 for 18. That's it today. Two receivers left, one on the right. The Badger 45-yard line, second down, a mix-up, and now a toss to the left. Newbie, it went behind him, and he'll have to pounce on it near midfield. Just a play that was out of whack from the get-go. Quarterback and running back on different pages, and then a poor pitch. Newbie falls on at the Badger 49, third and 12 for the Huskers.
Should have maybe looked over at that play call another time to see what was going on, because that was a bad play from the start, and then a real kind of lackadaisical pitch, like,
it's not a
not
smart
a lot of
play.
Urgency no. With that play.
Bad play went worse. Huskers fortunate to maintain the possession. Three receivers right, one on the left. Third down for Tommy Armstrong, and the Huskers offense takes the snap. Armstrong rolling right, chase by Austin Hudson, who knocked it out, and they're going to say it's a live ball near midfield, and a scramble for it, and the Badgers have it. How's the freshman Austin Hudson knocking it loose? We'll see whether this will get reviewed, but at the moment the Badgers have it at their own 49-yard line, and that was Caputo who fell on it. Hudson, the freshman out of Tampa, Florida, knocking it free from the quarterback.
You know, I think Caputo missed it the first go around, and it bounced back to him.
Yeah, I think that's a fumble.
I think that's going to hold up. Arm was moving.
The review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. As a result, Nebraska has lost their challenge and is charged a timeout.
9:36 to play. Badgers lead 52-17. And the turnover, let's give credit to Austin Hudson, young man getting some reps and forcing a turnover.
Give some credit to this Wisconsin defense. Nebraska had 86 yards in the first quarter, 84 yards since the first quarter.
Yeah, that's a great point. Only 170 total yards for the Huskers. Melvin Gordon has rushed for 408. Stavi remains the quarterback. Ogumbo Wally, the running back, and Dari gets a handoff to the 50, 45, down to the 43-yard line of Nebraska. Josh Mitchell, the cornerback, up to make the tackle. Gain of 8. Ogumbo Wally, when he plays, has played well, averaging 5.5 yards per carry. Remember, he made the position switch from defense to, you know, getting in the offensive backfield. He's been doing work in special teams. Man out of Milwaukee. It's kind of fun to watch.
And it's important, these snaps that he's getting right now. As we saw what happened earlier in this game when Clement got hurt. Now you're worried about your number three tailback at least having some seasoning.
Real right comes out wide to the left. George rushing to the right. Derek Strauss, the fullback. Ogumbo Wally, the tailback. And another carry for Dari, picking his way over the left side. And moving a stack near the 41, which is what he needs for the first down. Looks like he'll have it. Itching it closer to the 40-yard line of Nebraska.
So it's also important reps for the backup O-line. Some of those backup linemen in there getting to play. That's important.
Those are great points, because this is where young players really establish their base and start figuring out that they can play at this level. They're out there, they're getting these reps, and it's building that experience so that when they're called upon to expand their role, they're going to be ready for it.
Yeah, Walker Williams working at left tackle. Ray Ball, right guard. Hayden Beagle, right tackle. From the 40-yard line of Nebraska, first and 10. And Stavi will give it to Ogumbo Wally again to the 40. Dari cutting left, 35, still up to the 30, inside the 30, down to the 28-yard line. Well, the 28 of Nebraska's second down, or excuse me, first and 10, Wisconsin. And a handoff Ogumbo Wally to the 25. Dari to the 20 and pulls his way through to the 19-yard line. On the tackle, Courtney Love, redshirt freshman out of Youngstown, Ohio, to the same high school as did his head coach back in the day, Cardinal Mooney High School. Bo Pelini attended that school.
Nebraska goes home to play Minnesota and then finishes on the road at Iowa.
Minnesota played Ohio State tough today, but the Buckeyes won in Minneapolis, 31-24. Iowa beat Illinois 30-14. Badgers back into the Case IH red zone. 7:10 remaining, 52-17 Wisconsin, grinding out another drive. And another carry for Ogumbo Wally. He is to the 15-yard line and down to the 14. Corey Cooper for the safeties on the tackle. And that's the first down run. Ball at the 14-yard line of the Huskers. First down, Wisconsin. the American Family Broadcast booth. 6:45 remaining. The snow is falling. And the roof has fallen on Nebraska here after the Huskers popped out to a 17-3 lead. Wisconsin now leads 52-17. Rushing wide to the right, motions to the left. And the handoff of Gumbawali off the right side. Dare inside the 10 and bounce to the turf at the 8-yard line. David Santos, a linebacker, on the stop. That was a gain of 6. A mark at the 8-yard line of the Huskers, second down and 4.
This incredible run of unanswered points by Wisconsin reminds me again of another game, the one at Ohio State, where the Badgers fell behind by a couple of touchdowns. And all of a sudden, it was a landslide the other way. And that doesn't happen very often in Columbus.
Back in 99, Tosh.
Yeah, Tosh, you remember that.
That was probably the key, the pivotal game in that entire season. We're down big and able to come back, and I don't think we lost the rest of the way.
You did not. Lost the conference opener to Michigan, and then that was it. Here's Ogunbowale straight ahead to the 5. Dare to the end zone. Touchdown, Wisconsin. Dare Ogunbowale into the end zone. 58-17, Wisconsin.
Ray Ball, nice job pulling around, kicking out, and Nebraska's defeated. They've been defeated for a little stretch here. That was very easy to get that into the
end zone. It's fun seeing Melvin Gordon, and probably as excited as anyone for Ogunbowale scoring. It looked like he got his mask pulled, too, or at least his shoulder pad.
Yeah, they're good buds. Roomies, I believe. Touchdown for Dare Ogunbowale as Melvin Gordon is a fired up young man. Bouncing around, happy for Dare, and the extra point from Rafael Gaglianoni is good. And we have a timeout on the field. 5:34 remaining, Wisconsin 59, Nebraska 17. Back in a moment, this is Badger football from Learfield Sports.
UW Health Sports Medicine, the healthcare team for the Badgers and proud sponsors of UW Athletics. Learn more at uwsportsmedicine.org.
As a Wisconsin Badgers football fan, you probably know a thing or two about consistent, top-quality performance. Hi, I'm Gary Leeper, general manager at Dairyland Seed. And for over 110 years, we've been delivering nothing but the industry's best seed designed to deliver higher yields and unmatched quality to farmers in all environments and conditions. So just as you can bet on Bucky dominating the ground game, you can count on Dairyland Seed to be your most valuable partner each and every season. Dairyland Seed, proud sponsor of Wisconsin football and Wisconsin farmers.
Hey Badger fans, Mott's Matt for Brewpub Lots and Lots of Pizzas. Absolutely loving these Dream Season Badger games from back in the day. Hey, speaking of back in the day, remember when frozen pizzas were like a piece of cardboard laden with a flavorless sauce, topped with ingredients you'd reach after 5 bites, then sparsely decorated with cheese? Well, not anymore. Brewpub Lots and Lots of Pizzas came along and were a game changer. A crispy, thin cracker crust topped with a bold sauce, loaded with quality meat and veggie toppings, then bombarded with over half a pound of award-winning mozzarella cheese. Brewpub Pizzas, the perfect pizza, no matter the season.
University of Wisconsin Carbone Cancer Center, providing cancer research, education, and treatment for people throughout Wisconsin and Northern Illinois. Information at uwhealth.org/cancer. UW Health, providing specialty and primary care for all ages throughout Wisconsin. Information on UW Health physicians and clinics and on University of Wisconsin Hospital, available on the web at uwhealth.org.
Just see how it goes, Tausch. Give it a try. First down, new quarterback here for Nebraska. That is Riker Fife out there. And a handoff to Terrell Newby, who will get across the, just to the line of scrimmage, which is the Nebraska 21-yard line.
Given the number of runs that Gordon's had today, I know the Big Ten Network crew, film crew, the journey is here. How do you condense that? It might be the whole show or a miniseries starring Melvin Gordon.
Yeah, it's just an incredible performance. LaDainian Tomlinson had 406 yards in a game in 99. I don't know how many carries. Melvin has done his damage, 408 and 25 carries. Here's the handoff to Newby trying to bust off to his right, and Michael Trotter will bring him down across the 25 to the 26-yard line. And the Huskers looking at a third down and 5 as the snow continues to fall. It's been a pretty moderate snowfall here, not just the light stuff, a little more to it now. The field is starting to look more and more white. can still make out the yard markers, but not quite as clearly as you could about a half an hour or so ago.
Could be a little salt in the wound if Nebraska has to spend the night here tonight.
Yeah, just what they would want.
Melvin can invite him to his apartment.
There's Newby on third down. Not a lot happening up the middle, and he's cut down at the 28-yard line, and maybe the 29. Huskers still short of the stick with 3:50 and counting left in the game.
You know what I like about this? It's easy to not easy to get all these big numbers when you're playing those early games. You're playing Bowling Green. This was a good rushing defense that came in here tonight, and a big game, obviously, for kind of superiority in the Big Ten West. And to be able to do this, it really is. There's no words you can put to what this performance was today.
Yeah, you're right. There's still work to be done. They go to Iowa next week to the Badgers, and then Minnesota comes here in 2 weeks. Punt in the air, and Erickson waves everybody away. Hits inside the 20, inside the 10, inside the 5, and it checks up at about the 1. That's what a perfect punt is like. Sam Foltz. For Nebraska, he's been pretty much their highlight. Badgers starting at their own 1 with 3:09 to play, 59-17. Wisconsin, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. 10 for an ID. You're listening to Wisconsin football. Bill Bart, you don't have to punt. You have to play quarterback, but you're starting at your own 1. Here's the handoff to Ogunga. Wally didn't handle it. Ball is loose. Picked up by Nebraska's Nate Geary, and he takes it inside the 5 and down to the 2-yard line. So not a clean exchange as Houston and Ogunga Wally could not mesh. And Nate Geary scoops it up. And Nebraska has a first and goal with 3 minutes remaining.
And that's the only thing you really worry about in that situation. Make sure you have the ball.
And what you put that, you factor the fact in that these guys probably haven't done a lot of ball exchanges, that they just got into the ball game. The ball slick, all those things. You want to still finish this game up strong, especially the way this defense has performed. They've performed better than the 17 points that they've given up.
Yeah, you're right. First and goal. Just inside the 3-yard line. Here's the handoff to Terrell Newby running right and into the end zone. Touchdown, Nebraska. As Newby finds the edge of the right side. And it's now 59-23, Wisconsin.
Newby is a player that they were figuring on playing even a little bit more today, depending on Abdullah, whether or not he was going to be ready to go. And as it turned out, Abdullah was ready, though his numbers weren't really reflective of a healthy Amir Abdullah.
No, well, everything right. Is skewed today, too. Yep. His running back numbers.
18 carries, 69 yards for Abdullah. Extra point is in the air, and it is good. We'll take another break. 2:54 remaining. 59-24. Wisconsin back in 1 minute. It's Badger football from Learfield Sports. Oh, fumble they recover inside the 5. So short field, really short field. Kick off to Natrell Jamerson, and he'll go ahead and take the touchback. Badgers start at their 25.
Now that the Badgers have taken care of their end of the weekend bargain, what's in store for the Packers and the Eagles tomorrow?
Do they have a game tomorrow?
Yeah, I heard
they do. You know, I think, man, Green Bay is playing lights out football right now. And, you know, Shady McCoy, that rushing attack, let's see. It'll be interesting to see how the newly minted defense from last week, how will it hold up against what I think is a really good rushing attack.
Do you like the fact Clay Matthews is playing inside and is going to move around a little bit?
Well, it worked last week. We'll see how it goes this next week. But it definitely was effective as a surprise last week. Now, a little bit of scheming, see what they can do differently.
And everything worked last week, huh? Against the Bears. Bart Houston remains the quarterback. And on first down, the handoff to Ogunbo Wally, running over the right side of the line, across the 25 to the 27-yard line as we play this one out. Courtney Love, redshirt freshman linebacker, on the tackle.
If you're wondering why Dan Vols is still out there, Benders had an injury to a backup lineman, Aiden McNamara, this week in practice, and he would be in the game now, but I think it was Wednesday's practice, Matt, wasn't
it?
Because they don't want to take the redshirt off Michael Dieter, who's being groomed as that backup for next year.
Yeah, Aiden from right here in Madison, certainly wish him all the best as he recovers from that injury. The 27-yard line of Wisconsin, second down and 8. Here's the handoff again to Ogunbowale, getting a good workload. He'll fight his way up to about the 30-yard line. Well, we really have Wisconsin basketball game number two of the season for the Badgers tomorrow against Chattanooga. Our coverage starts at 11, the tip-off set for high noon. Wisconsin winning last night over Northern Kentucky, 62-31. They raise the Final Four banner at the Kohl Center. A good night was had for Badger fans. Minute 35 and counting left in the game. Third down and four for Wisconsin at its own 31-yard line. And Houston will hand off to Dari Ogunbowale again. He'll get the first down, crashing across the 35 to the 36. And that'll wrap her up. 1:21 to play. 59-24 Wisconsin.
The defense, this game is all going to be about Melvin Gordon and the rushing attack and all this, of the things. But really, the offense put this defense in tough situations, holding them to a field goal right away. And I really thought the linebackers today, you know, Beagle has been on a tear lately. But Schobert, Trotter, Landish really set the tone and just played lights out football.
And those unsung members on the line of scrimmage who take on the blockers to free up the linebackers made some plays too, most notably Warren Herring forcing a fumble. So he got involved as well. They all took part in history today, watched a little bit, witnessed it, didn't we?
Sure did. Badgers in their victory formation. Houston taking a knee, time winding down. The Badgers will need to snap it one more time. 35 seconds and counting left in the game. Well, there's talk about this program's need for a signature victory. This is one with an exclamation point. As the Badgers roll, work to be done, but a special day here in Madison as Houston takes a knee and time winds down. And after a tough start, it turned into a dominant performance for Gary Anderson's Wisconsin Badgers as this game has come to an end. Record-setting day, Melvin Gordon rushes for an FBS single-game record, 408 yards. The Badgers, after falling behind early, 17-3, storm back and win it 59-24.
In my business, we're constantly talking about teams or individuals needing to make a statement. What do you think? Melvin Gordon, did he make a statement here today?
I think that's probably an understatement that you just made, Mike. You know, his explosivity today was on high regard, but it just, his talent is so unbelievable, and it's great that he's able to showcase it in a big game like this, and now to get that national attention even ramped up a little bit more is pretty impressive.
Hashtag Gordon to Gotham.
Because of this, we made Ford Super Duty the most capable heavy-duty pickup ever. Because of this, we built Ford F-150 with 375 horsepower and best-in-class payload.
Rescue 614 inbound.
Because of this, we built Ford Ranger with the terrain management system. And because Ford trucks are built for this, you made Ford America's best-selling brand.
You've heard the saying, if it looks like bacon and it tastes like sausage, it's probably Johnsonville Sausage Strips. Oh, you never heard that? Well, sausage strips are pretty new. They're strips of sausage in amazing flavors like maple and chorizo. You can find this meaty miracle by the bacon, even though it's sausage.
Whoa.
Get to B-Dubs on Thursdays for buy one, get one free boneless wings. Or as we like to say, 100% more wings. That's right. When you buy boneless wings on Thursdays, you get the same amount of wings for $0.00. Basically, the second order is 100% off. So get here for buy one, get one free boneless wings on Boneless Thursdays. Buffalo Wild Wings. Roar!
Buy one, get one of equal value free. Dine in at participating locations. Takeout is limited and may vary by location. Size exclusions may apply while supplies last. Limit one offer per customer. Not valid with any other coupon.
on the Badger Sports Network. You've been listening to the Wisconsin Football Dream Season, presented by American Family Insurance. Also brought to you by Alliant Energy, powering beyond. Case IH, enter the red zone with Case IH. Visit caseih.com/badgers. U.S. Bank, helping individuals and businesses work toward their financial goals. Equal housing lender, member FDIC. And by DeKalb. Winning has roots. Perform at your best with DeKalb Brand Corn. Welcome to the Badger Postgame Show.
Welcome into the Ford Postgame Show. And boy, do we have a story to tell on today's postgame show as the Badgers defeated Nebraska 59-24. Remember, they trailed early in the game 17-3. So obviously things got a lot better for the home team on this November day of 2014. Let's take a look at our Annex Wealth Management difference maker of the game. Annex Wealth Management, know the difference. I gotta tell you, it's a pretty easy call. Melvin Gordon with a record-breaking day, 408 rushing yards. He needed all of three quarters to do it. Not bad on 25 carries, better than 16 yards per tote and four touchdowns on the day. Just an incredible performance by one of the best running backs in school history. Stay with us when we continue. We'll take a look at next week's Dream Season matchup. Our Ford postgame show continues in a moment. This is the Wisconsin Football Dream Season from Learfield IMG College.
In these challenging, uncertain, uncharted times, you stand strong. No matter the conditions you face, you get the job done. You are the backbone of our communities.
We believe in education. We believe in public schools. At WEA Member Benefits, we believe in helping Wisconsin public school employees and their families achieve their financial goals by providing personal insurance, retirement and investment, and financial planning programs that are designed specifically for the education community. WEABenefits.com.
Welcome back to the Ford Postgame Show. We hope you enjoyed our look back at one of the greatest performances ever by a Wisconsin running back, Melvin Gordon's 408-yard performance against Nebraska in 2014. Join us next Friday at 5 o'clock along the Badger Network stations as well as on the Badger YouTube channel as we look at the greatest running back of them all, Ron Dayne, and the 1999 game between the Badgers and the Iowa Hawkeyes. Thanks for joining us. For those of you watching on YouTube, coming up next, the fifth quarter, presented by American Family Insurance. Thanks to all of you for joining us here today. This is the Wisconsin Football Dream Season, Learfield IMG College. We'll be right back.
You've been listening to the Wisconsin Football Dream Season, presented by American Family Insurance. Also brought to you by UW Health Sports Medicine, treating the Badgers, treating you. Visit uwsportsmedicine.org. American Family Insurance, because your dreams deserve a champion. Cenex, powered locally. And by Case IH. Enter the red zone with Case IH. Visit caseih.com/Badgers. The preceding has been a Learfield IMG College presentation of the Badger Sports Network.